could it well be Candlestick Lake outside Candlestick Park today, but inside it's unusually pleasant considering all the bad weather forecast we've had throughout this week as the Redskins come to town to face the 49ers. Hi, I'm Pat Summerall, and put to rest all those words about this being Joe Montana's team. It's Steve Young's team. In fact, George Seifert, the head coach of the 49ers, tells Steve Young that personally before every game they play. I'm Pat Summerall here with John Madden. And John, it seems sort of fitting that these two years should be in a game of this magnitude.
Yeah, you know, if you just look at what's happened since 1981, the Redskins and the 49ers, these two teams have had the best record in football. They've played in 10 out of the last 11 NFC championship games. They've won 7 of the last Super Bowl. So when you get to the playoffs now, these two teams should play each other. You know, Joe Gibbs came in last night and he said they're calling this game Mission Impossible. Joe Gibbs likes that kind of talk. He said, and we just kind of keep going and going and going because they still are the defending champions. They have that championship fiber. But I tell you, they're going to need a big game today for Mark Rippon and the posse. Because on the other side, they have Steve Young, who's the MVP in the league. He's throwing to Jerry Rice, who may be the best wide receiver who's ever played the game on one side. John Taylor on the other side. Brent Jones is a tight end. Ricky Waters is a running back. I'll tell you, the 49ers have everything, and the Redskins are going to have their work cut out today.
The 49ers will open with the football. It's a soggy, heavy field. Candlestick, Chip Lowmiller set to kick it off. It will affect the traction on both sides of the ball. I'm not sure who that helps, but it won't be what they call a fast track as Lowmiller hits it in the direction of Alan Grant, but this will be Mark Logan. Logan slips down, lost the ball momentarily, and down he goes there. Brantley made sure he stayed down. Steve Young opens at quarterback for the 49ers. What a year he's had in front of him, and they've all had good years too. Wallace, McIntyre, Cipolla, Foster, Harris, Barton back at right tackle, Brent Jones the tight end. Ricky Waters and Tom Rathman, who had a game's rest 2 weeks ago, and then Rice and John Taylor are wide. Steve Young. Jones in motion, and Young goes right to work to Rice, and he could be off to the track. Jerry Rice into Redskin territory, out of bounds at the 48. 35 yards on the first play.
We were talking to Steve Young yesterday, and he said he likes to get the ball early in the game to Jerry Rice. He sure did.
Washington's defensive line, Collins, Johnson, Buck, and Mann in front. Andre Collins, Govea, and Wilbur Marshall. Mayhew, Johnson, Edwards, and Copeland, the secondary. Redskins secondary. Two or three of the cover men appeared to slip on that first play when they were covering Rice. He's made a lot of people slip. Outside it comes to Waters. Down and out of bounds at about the 42-yard line of Washington. A gain of 5. Knocked out by Andre Collins.
And this is playoff football right here. You get the defensive guy, you get the offensive guy, and you get the coach right in the middle of it. It must be playoff time.
Solid ingredients. Solid coaching by that guy.
Tell you, over a period of time, you know, it was Bill Walsh's team, and tell you, since George Seifert has taken over, he has done an excellent job. Ricky Waters got knocked right into George Seifert. In fact, he got knocked in there twice. I think George Seifert throws a left.
I think he does.
I think I see the left hand coming out of there.
I know he messed up his hair. That's not a good sign.
Yeah, well, he doesn't worry about the hair. Some of them do. He's not one of them.
Waters cut back and swift. Got perhaps a yard. And that turf, it's been raining and raining and raining. And, John, you've been here. You know it's been an unusually wet week.
Well, you know
Bay
what
area.
Happens, and this field cannot take the wet because it's lower than sea level, and it used to be the same thing over at the Oakland Coliseum, and when it gets wet here, it just stays there, so footing is going to be a problem. This is going to be a heavy field at the start, and it's going to get heavier as the game goes on.
Three wide receivers set up for the 49ers. Mike Sherrard split wide right. The young back to throw it. Steps up in the pocket and wheels it out to Brent Jones, who has a great feel for the passing game, as they say. And he illustrates it one more time. A gain of 23 knocked out of bounds by Edwards.
Excellent pass protection here, Pat. Here's what it all starts with, because Steve Young doesn't go to his first receiver. Watch the time he has. He's looking out to his right, comes back to his middle, finds Brent Jones going across, and he hits a wide open tight end. But that's the thing about this team is it all starts here. You know, you talk about the wide receivers in the back, but they have a very good offensive line, an offensive line that can give Steve Young the protection that he needs.
First and 10 at the 20. Taylor wide left. Fake to Waters, misses Young. Takes the pass out of bounds. Doesn't go out of bounds. Cuts it down to about the 5. Danny Copeland tripped him up. Young scrambled for 15.
And I tell you, and that was an organized scramble. This is a bootleg. They're going to get the backs going to the right. You see, he fakes to the right, puts the ball out here. Now it's an option runner pass. But I think he was going to run all the way. He just used that fake of the pass just to keep that defense off. And Steve Young is one of those quarterbacks that when he gets on the sideline or near the sideline, he's not going to automatically go out of bounds.
That was illustrated right there. First and goal from the 5, the 49ers. Very impressive on this opening drive. Here's Young. The Redskins had a shot at it. It went right through one of the Redskins, and Taylor made an outstanding catch.
That's the thing about Steve Young. You know, he can move, and he moved out of the pocket like 3 times. Here it is. It's a bootleg again. It's the same play that he had just run the play before on. You see, it just goes right through A.J. Johnson's hand. Gouveia was there first. It went by Gouveia and then through A.J. Johnson and then finally to the touchdown to John Taylor.
You talk about amazing concentration for that ball to go past one player and through another and him still be able to make the catch. That's remarkable. Extra point good. 7-0 San Francisco, and a scuffle erupts again. Touchdown again. Young, pass Gouveia, through Johnson, touchdown Taylor.
This is an energy-efficient 23,000 BTU air conditioning unit with enough power to cool down a 1,500-square-foot house. But this unit isn't cooling a house. It's cooling the spacious interior of a remarkable new luxury sedan. New Chrysler Concorde. Nothing less than the renaissance of the American car.
Start with your average quarterback. Excuse me, above average quarterback. And listen to the way he has to communicate. Pretty complicated. And that's just on the field. Now add coaches communicating with assistants upstairs, officials with the press box, teams with league headquarters, and they all have to communicate with each other. But the NFL talks to only one company to make that happen. GTE, telecommunications consultant to the NFL.
If I want to keep playing baseball, I'm going to have to keep working. There's no off season anymore. And when I get sore, I take Advil. To last, you stick with what works.
Advil. Advanced medicine for pain.
Our 6-inch meatball sub features meatballs and sauce on bread I just baked, all for a low economical price. I won't say how low, but you'll probably find enough in the cushions of your couch.
The 6-inch meatball sub, only $1.69, only at Subway.
NFC divisional playoff, the 49ers. Very impressive on that opening drive. 6 plays, 83 yards. 3 minutes and 12 seconds. Taylor got the touchdown. Young, 68 yards passing he accumulated. The big one, 35 yards to Rice. 15 yards running he had. Brian Mitchell and Danny Copeland back deep for Washington. Kofor to kick off for the 49ers. Mitchell. Brian Mitchell out of bounds. Mark Rippon opens at quarterback. In front of him, sort of a rebuilt offensive line, Lachey, Ray Brown, McKenzie at center, Sarett, Simmons, and Ron Middleton, the tight end. Biner, Monk, Sanders, and Clark, the receiver. That all changes from play to play. Biner will be the setback behind Rippon. Fake to Biner. Rippon throws it away. Monk in Rippon's aim, but the aim wasn't very good. On defense, the 49ers. Fagan, Carter, and Holt, the front three. Romanowski, Walter, DeLong, and Tim Harris, the leading sacker. The linebackers, Griffin and Davis, the corners. Dana Hall, the number one draft choice, the rookie. Along with Whitmore in the secondary. Second and 10, Washington. To Biner. Outside the 25 to the 27, a pickup of 4.5, perhaps. Mike Walter made the tackle. Earlier today, the Bills, still on a high, perhaps, from their comeback last week over Houston, beat Pittsburgh 24-3. Buffalo going to their third straight AFC championship game. Third and 6. The field is sloppy, and it's going to be a factor.
And it's going to get worse.
That was Monk in motion, and Rippon with the pressure on. Lost the football, tossed it to Biner at the last minute. But the heat was put on by Pierce Holt.
I tell you, Pierce Holt made a heck of a move. He came right up the gut. You're going to see Pierce Holt is right here, and he makes a move here, and then boom, straight up the gut on that play. Watch it. This is the thing. Then you call that a swim move. He hits Lorette with his inside hand, brought his outside arm over, and the next thing he saw was Mark Rippon.
That is called a sack.
I don't know what the heck Mark Rippon was doing or what he saw, but that was an awfully dangerous thing to do,
wasn't it? So it's a loss of 7 yards. Alan Grant back deep to the 49ers for Goodburn's punt. They kick away from him. It takes a San Francisco bounce. And they'll take over at about midfield, leading 7-0 already. 29 yards on the punt. That's all.
Above all else, I had to win her. But should I go here or there? Or just put my pants on backwards? Would she feel it was a cosmic roller coaster to the stars? Or just a metaphysical bus ride to Palookaville? I seized the moment.
Share the six-pack. Coors Light. The right beer now.
In pilot jargon, it's called a walk-around. You see them do it before every takeoff of every plane. What you don't see are their qualifications to fly those planes. It takes them years and thousands of hours of experience. And every year, they're schooled and tested. No exceptions. Because when you're a United pilot, you hold a lot more in your hands than just the controls. Come fly the airline that's United the world. Come fly the friendly skies.
We had bought Japanese products 5 times, and over the past 12 months or so, the maintenance bills just got to be out of hand.
How you doing? You're
welcome. So this is your new van?
It sure is. You like it?
Boy, that's something. What is this?
Chrysler Town & Country.
I felt pretty strongly about giving America another chance. Chrysler seems to have really been improving their product, and that was exactly what we wanted.
How you doing?
With over 3 million sold, Chrysler's minivans have been a part of more lives than all other minivans combined.
CBS Sports coverage of the National Football Conference Divisional Playoff is sponsored by Chrysler Plymouth, a division of the Chrysler Corporation. Coors Light, the silver bullet, is the right beer now. And by United, come fly the airline that's uniting the world. Come fly the friendly skies.
Back in muddy Candlestick Park. Although it's not raining now, the field is very soft, and you can look at the condition of it. It's already torn up, and it's going to get worse, as John Madden said. Young to water. Good block in front of him by McIntyre.
You know, that first drive of the 49ers was excellent. They had six plays. It was all a Steve Young drive. He all passes, and the only one run was his run. And the 49er offensive coordinator now is Mike Shanahan, and he's the guy right there in the middle. And he has the same thing that Bill Walsh used to have, where he would script the first 15 plays. So he has them. In fact, on Friday night, he sits down and he decides the first 15 plays they're going to use. I don't know how the other six or seven are going to go, but those first six were some good ones.
Second and 10. Young out of the pocket, scrambling, first down, fumble. Flag on the play. The Redskins have the football recovered by Brad Edwards. There was a flag on the play.
The Redskins felt coming into this game. In fact, Richie Pettibone says the only chance we have here is by getting turnovers.
Illegal
motion. Least four.
Number 80 on
There's
the offense.
There's number one.
That penalty is declined. First down.
Red Cashin, the referee. Penalty declined, so the Redskins will take over at their own 37.
This is one thing happens when you run with that ball in a motion that is a wild motion. Things are going to happen. Now watch number 60, Fred Stokes here. You see, you can't see him coming. And that's usually where the ball gets stripped, is when the guy comes in behind and does that chop move on you.
And more and more they do that.
Right. And I think Lawrence Taylor first started it. Fred Stokes did it that time.
That's Biner to the 40. He got 3 yards. DeLong and Carter made the stop.
Yeah, it's funny with these big games. You can say that this team has the offense and, you know, against this defense, and they have to do this and they have to do that. And the one thing you can't account for are turnovers. We talked to Steve Young yesterday. That's what he said. We can't have any turnovers. We talked to Richie Pettibone, the defensive coordinator, the defensive coach of the Redskins. He says, we need turnovers. If we don't get turnovers, we can't win this game.
We can't win without it. A lot of those names that you mentioned being mentioned as other head coaches. This is Biner, no game. Shanahan, of course, has been rumored going to Denver. Richie Pettibone, they talk about taking over for Mike Ditka in Chicago.
You know that Richie Pettibone has been one of the top assistant coaches in this league for so many years, and you know that his day is going to come. I mean, he's going to be a head coach in this league someday, whether it's the Chicago Bears or not. But I mean, he is a bright, bright coach.
Third and 7. Ball at the 40. Ripping to throw it. Out to Gary Clark. That should be enough for first down. 8-yard pickup. Stopped by Magruder. Ripping had to throw that ball a long way for a simple square out.
I know, but you know, Gary Clark is the type of guy that always thinks he's open, and you know what? Most of the time, he really is. Whether you need that play just like that to get a first down, Clark will get it for you. You need the big one, he'll get that one for you. And I don't know if you could measure competitiveness in a guy. I don't know many people who would measure higher than Gary Clark.
That is very true. Rip and fake. He has Monk, and he hit him. Art Monk. Out of bounds at the 49er 15. If there's a questionable part of this 49er machine, it would be against the pass.
And that's what the Redskins felt. They felt if we can get the time, we can get some running going so we can play fake, which that was, that we can get deep against these guys. They have a young, inexperienced secondary. You know, Dana Hall is a rookie back there at free safety. They want to take advantage of him, and they did. How do they block Tim Harris? You keep your tight end in, and you have Jim Lachey, one of the best tackles in the league. Put two guys on him, he's about their only dangerous pass rusher.
Ricky Sanders, the lone split receiver, split out wide to the right. They go to Biner, to the left, not much. DeLong stopped him after two.
And now we're getting into an area where the Redskins have really had trouble this year. If you've looked, they've been inside this 20, the red zone they call it, and the Redskins aren't the only ones that have had trouble this year in that area, but they seem to have more trouble than anyone else. They scored a touchdown 36% of the time. The NFL average is 48%. I know when I was coaching, I used to think you ought to be up there around 75%. You get inside the 20, you ought to score a touchdown. But defenses in this area have gotten much, much better.
When you have more field goals than you do touchdowns, that's not a good sign. Outside the bunker, he breaks away from two 49er tacklers and gets a Redskin first down at the 3. A gain of 10. It'll be first and goal. Washington finally taken down by Romanowski.
And that's the thing that you have to do, is you have to be able to tackle in the open field. And that was Romanowski. That was, you're going to see Keith DeLong come out here and miss the tackle. You see they got him pinned in here. He cuts there. You see Romanowski misses first. That causes a little spinner. Then the spinner right in there behind is DeLong. And then he spins right out of both of those things and gets the ball down inside the 5-yard line. But boy, tackling is such a big part of this game. If you don't do that, you can't be a good defense.
Miner again. Didn't get in. Got down to about the 1.5. Stopped by Michael Carter. He's going to be hard to move on a field like this.
Yeah, that's the thing. It's you know, if you can't block the nose tackle, then you better start thinking of running a couple holes outside, because if you can't block that nose tackle, then you can't obviously run over the center, but you can't run over either guard area.
Ricky Sanders was the deep back. Now he moves out in the slot to the left, leaving Beiner by himself behind Ripley. And Beiner gets the carry. Can't find much of a gap to go through. Whitmore made the stop. No gain.
The Redskins stayed in regular formation. They had 3 wide receivers, 1 tight end. Usually they go to a form of a couple of tight ends down in this area, but they're not. Joe Gibbs wanted the threat of the pass, even though he still ran that counter tray play. The 49ers want to squeeze that counter tray, take the hole inside away, and if there is any hole, make them bounce that one to the outside.
Griffin in the corner, way out of Park's reach. And one more time, we'll see Chip Lowmiller. This is exactly what you were talking about a minute ago.
You know what happens? You have a lack of success there, and then you get down there, and it's just hard to have confidence. And they didn't look like they had confidence in, one, the plays that they were calling, or running those plays that they called.
It just looked a little unsettled from the very beginning. Miller. He was hooking them badly in pregame practice, and that one just barely got inside the upright. 7-3.
Ooh, what's this? She sees my V6. Oh, buy me, please buy me. Ooh, she likes my spoiler, my low profile tires, sports suspension. She wants me. Uh-oh. She thinks I'm too expensive. I can fix that.
Perfect.
Ow!
Duster. A lot to love for under $10,000 from Chrysler Plymouth.
I'm so happy.
My boyfriend will love it.
I'm so unhappy.
Hey, I'm vain. Of course I'm vain. That's why I comb my hair the way I do. I stay in shape the way I do. That's why I use Power Stick.
50% more wetness and odor fighters per stroke. Power Stick by Fabergé. Power that won't let you down.
I told you I was vain.
All-Pro quarterback Dan Marino.
When the game is over and the pain starts, I want fast relief and no odor. So I use Sports Cream, a strong pain-relieving rub that doesn't make me smell like a medicine chest. Sports Cream, fast relief and no odor.
This is the runaround. You get a lot of it these days instead of service. To not get the runaround, call on your Allstate agent.
Allstate?
Who promises
a tree blew down on my house.
That after talking with you about your claim,
my loblolly pine stuck in my roof.
His claims expert will call.
Okay, I'll be right here.
Usually in an hour.
Hello?
That's why you're in good hands with Allstate.
Everyone's all right. Don't worry about the tree.
Candlestick Park for the NFC Divisional Playoff Game. The 49ers and the Redskins. Pat Summerall, John Madden. 4:26 left to play in the first quarter. It's the 49ers 7, the Redskins 3. Grant and Logan back deep. Low Miller to kick it off. I think he'll return this one. At the end line.
You see the defensive lineman. In fact, as Pierce Holt there, he's looking at the pictures. You know, they take shots for the lineman from the end zone, and then the lineman will look at the different shots and you know the plays and the blocking schemes and all those things. Half of it, when defensive linemen look at pictures, half of that is a bluff. I mean, they just get down there in the dirt and mud and roll around, and they don't know what they're looking at.
Really. They don't know. Young. Misread, perhaps, or an incorrect pattern. Ricky Waters, I think, was the intended receiver.
Yeah, you look at this field, Pat, you can see where the problem is going to be. It's going to be right here in the middle of the field. If you look all the way down, all that stuff down there is mud and dirt and is starting to get dug up already. And I think that's going to be the problem area. The sides look pretty good right now, but the whole middle of the field is dug up.
Waters is on the move, second and 10. Back to throw it again. Going to have to hurry. To Rice. A couple of yards short of the first down. Rice wrestled down by Danny Copeland.
I'll tell you, Shane Collins made him have to hurry on that one. If you're going to look for Rice, he's the guy to look for. They have him going outside. They have him going inside. They have him coming underneath. They have him running option things. Just anything to get the ball to him. Now, here's where the pressure comes from. 91. You see Shane Collins there. He gets right by Steve Wallace. And if Steve Young doesn't throw the ball in, he's going to take a sack. You're not going to see Shane Collins beat Steve Wallace a lot today.
Gary Rice out of bounds and a flag on the play. Knocked out by A.J. Johnson. You know, John, when you talk with the other 49er players about Jerry Rice, Red Cashin gives the indication that they'll mark off some more. When you talk about Jerry Rice, they just shake their heads in admiration and say, whatever he gets,
face mask,
he deserves.
47 on the defense, 5 yards.
And that's right, because Jerry Rice, I mean, he's not only so good, but he works harder than anyone else. Yeah, I mean, he's out there. He's the first guy out on the field every day. He's the last guy to leave. He runs every play as hard or harder than anyone else. And anything that he gets, and every player feels this, that anything Jerry Rice gets, he deserves. In fact, I think he got a little break in that last call.
I think he did indeed. First and 10, 49. Young gets to Waters. Hit behind the line. In fact, I thought it was interesting talking to George Seifert. He said when he thinks he might be practicing too hard or too long, that Jerry Rice is his barometer.
Yeah, you always have to have that. You know, there are some guys that if you use them as a barometer, they get tired during stretching exercises. And they'll tell you that's tonight. You're some of these big old linemen. But as George Seifert says, when you look at Jerry Rice and he starts to get tired, or you're practicing too long, or too hard, and you can see it in his face and his body, you know it's time to quit and take the club to the house.
Time to go to the barn. Second and 11. Throw. Pass complete. Up the middle to Brent Jones.
Yeah, this is what you have to like about this 49er attack, because they throw the ball. I mean, they get it to Rice, they get it to Taylor, they get it to Brent Jones, to Ricky Waters. They throw it all around. Jumpy Gathers is complaining there that he gets help. Watch what they do to Jumpy Gathers here, 97. All the 49ers are saying he's the best pass rusher on that team. Guy McIntyre knows it. In fact, Jumpy Gathers has a move that's called a forklift. He gets under you, pulls you into him, lifts you up, and walks you back into the quarterback. Guy McIntyre pulled a forklift on the forklift.
If he was complaining about being held, he was right. He had a legitimate complaint. This is Waters. Left side hit by Andre Collins. Picked up two.
Well, Jumpy Gathers is like 290 pounds, and he's one of the best pass-rushing tackles in football. And Guy McIntyre is a Pro Bowl guard, but he's not a big guy. I mean, Guy McIntyre has to fight to stay around 260, 265, so he knows that he's going to be outsized in that battle. And then Jumpy got that move, that old forklift, and he does it to the biggest, and he does it to the best. And Guy McIntyre knows he better get a little help to block Jumpy Gathers.
That'll be an interesting match to watch. It's going to happen right here. No, it doesn't. They try to cut Jumpy. And Jumpy hit Young just as he let it go, intended for Rice. Wallace tried to cut him.
Well, what they did, yeah, Steve Wallace is going to come down right here on him, and then what they're going to do is go a play pass. You see, they're faking the run. Steve Wallace takes out his knee. Jumpy Gathers has a bad knee, but if you're going to go for a guy's knee, you better keep him down. Jumpy Gathers gets up, and when he gives just a little bump, look at, here's Jumpy Gathers. Here, after a little bump, there's about a 3-yard separation there. So a bump will average about 3 or 4 or 5 yards.
You know, when you say Jumpy, that to me is sort of, you're talking about a little nervous guy. But Jumpy is not a little guy.
No, it means he makes the other guy jumpy.
The pressure again. And Young comes out of there, and he's off. Slides at the 20. Monty Coleman chasing Steve Young. A 23-yard run. You can't call that a scramble. That's a run.
Yeah, and you can't give Steve Young a lane. That's the thing. He's going to go back. He's going to look. Now, here's what he sees. If we stop it right here, he's looking to pass over here. There's nothing here. But look at this running lane that he has here, and he has a running lane here. Now, they didn't give him any pass lanes. They didn't give him any pass coverage. But look at that big running lane that they gave him. Once he gets by that first group, he has 15 yards.
That's the end of the first quarter. With the score, the 49ers 7, the Redskins 3.
During the Roman era, 28 was considered old.
In the 1800s, 60 was over the hill.
You got it!
McMuffin.
Make that two. Big Mac. Two times.
Mm-hmm.
It's two for two time at McDonald's. Now you can have two of your two favorite sandwiches for only $2. Great tasting Egg McMuffin for breakfast, two for $2. Or delicious Big Mac for lunch or dinner, two for $2.
Jocelyn?
Juliet? You know each other?
Two-timer.
What you want is what you get.
You better take that to go.
At McDonald's today.
You were on a Honda commercial a few years ago, right?
Yeah, they made me the Honda Family of the Year.
And how many did you have?
We had 10 over a 5-year period.
So now what happened? You switched to something else.
A Plymouth Voyager. I got in it and I drove it. Yeah. I said, I love this thing. Comfortable, easy to drive, wonderful to look at. Take it for a drive. That's all I got to tell you to do. And once you sit in the seat, you find the comfort, you find the way it handles, you find its versatility, you won't buy anything else.
With over 3 million sold, Chrysler's minivans have been a part of more lives than all other minivans combined.
A night of horror for a family terrorized by an abusive father.
Her husband was killing her.
A very important rescue 911 Tuesday.
Well, usually they're seagulls when you're at Candlestick. Now there are people.
Yeah, I know.
Field.
You know, and the interesting thing, Pat, these guys are all behind the Redskin defense. Where the 49ers are going. They're not working on the field where the 49ers have already been. These guys have to be 49er fans. Look at where they're working on the field. They're working from the 20-yard line in where the 49ers are going. No one cares where they've already been.
Water bounces away and bounces down to about the 10 before he's knocked out of bounds by Edwards.
There is an excitable guy, Ricky Waters. He was telling us yesterday, his dad tells him, something has to give, just don't ever let it be you. And he said he goes into every game thinking about that, and he never is going to let the thing that gives be him, just like that. You know, the 49ers, not only Ricky Waters there, but their receivers and everyone have done an outstanding job of making the Redskins miss tackles.
Waters got 15 yards. Rathman in the backfield with it. Waters again. Slipped down at about the 8. Govea pinned him after he slipped.
You know, Joe Gibbs has a thing he always tells his team to wear smart shoes. Don't wear dumb shoes. And that was one of his coaching points coming out here, that the Candlestick is going to be heavy. There's going to be a lot of mud, but it's okay. We practice in the mud. We know what we're doing. But wear your smart shoes. Don't wear any of those dumb shoes.
Second and goal. San Francisco's drive this time. 10 plays, 74 yards. Taylor, wide left. Rice, right. Young will throw it quickly. Taylor. Popped out of bounds by Martin Mayhew at about the 2. Pick up a 5.
Yeah, John Taylor had a broken leg this year. Oops, he just fumbled his mouthpiece. Let's see if he puts it back. You know, oh yeah, he's going to put it back, but he's going to wipe it off a couple times. You see, you're going to get it. You have to wipe that thing off a little first. But John Taylor is one of the most underrated players on this 49er team. Of course, it's going to be a lot easier for John Taylor and for Jerry Rice and for all of them if Darryl Green doesn't play today.
Third and goal at the 1. Rathman's turn. I don't know. And now I do know. He didn't get in. Wilbur Marshall led the Redskins charge. He's about a foot short, but a flag on the play.
I think they're going to call the 49ers for holding. It could be right here at the end of the line. Jamie Williams, number 81. Rathman had his shoulder square to the line, but he got hit and he got his shoulders turned perpendicular. But I think it didn't make any difference anyway, because this is going to be a penalty against the 49ers. In the replay, it looked like it's on Jamie Williams, the tight end.
Holding during the run. Number 81 on the offense. 10 yards, still third down.
If you can read lips, Red Cashin said number 81, and that's correct.
Yep. You see him, he just reaches out and grabs. He starts off with a hold, then he keeps a hold on Fred Stokes, number 60, and then it eventually becomes a takedown.
Third and goal from the 11. Taylor and Rice go left. Gerard is to the right. Taylor and Rice on the same side. It's a pretty good package. They give to Rathman. Monty Coleman knocked him down after a gain of 7. And the 49ers come on with the field goal unit.
And that's a big play. A big play by the defense here. Even though there was a penalty involved there, they still stopped Rathman on the goal line. And then Monty Coleman made that tackle. And you look at those plays and you say, well, it's not a heck of a lot. But those plays, or that penalty, or any way you want to look at it, could be a 4-point play if they make this field goal. If they don't, it's a 7-point defensive play.
We saw a 4-point play turn a game around last week in New Orleans. Hopefully is good with Bono holding, and it's 10-3 49ers.
A dozen of the Argyle socks and the striped shirt.
I admire a guy who knows what he wants.
I'll take the polka dot tie as well.
Not the way I would go, but a bold choice. This guy's a doer.
Here you go.
We prefer this one.
What?
You pick the clothes, he picks the card? Who's doing the preferring around here? Stick with the American Express card. No interest, no revolving debt.
I prefer this one. And I prefer that tie.
Now that's more like it. The American Express card. Don't leave home without it.
Move it. Cool it. Silver. Bullet. Rock it. Smooth it. Play it, take it, pull it, silver.
right beer now. Grab it while you can.
Silver Bullet. Have a right beer now.
For his retirement, Neil McBain had no intention of slowing down. That's why Dean Witter mapped out his financial course with only one goal in mind. Victory. Dean Witter.
We measure success one investor at a time.
A Department of Energy study reveals that most American homes don't have enough insulation. And that means you. To find out what's right for your home, call Owens Corning at 1-800-GET-PINK.
For one golden night, the woman of a thousand faces is joining her friends for a million laughs.
This is your evening.
The Carol Burnett Show, a reunion Sunday.
This will give you a pretty good idea of the condition of the field and how important. Look at his left foot. Kofor's left foot. And sometimes that one becomes just as important, getting it planted correctly, as the foot with which you kick. Back out here, the field's in a little bit better shape. Brian Mitchell and Danny Copeland back deep for the Redskins. Kofor to kick off. Not much wind at Candlestick Park. It's going to be Mitchell at the eight with an alley. But they shut the alley and the door very quickly. 17-yard return.
Imagine a V8 engine that's incredibly powerful, yet easy to maintain. Imagine a 5-speed automatic that's responsive, yet seamlessly smooth. Imagine a luxurious sedan that can actually help make you a better driver. Introducing the BMW 740 IL. A car that will have the competition playing catch-up once again. Imagine that.
Mind readers, communicating with other minds. The next slide, please. Powerful messages.
Come on!
You think what I'm thinking?
You know I am.
Come on! Come on! Let me show you where it's at.
When you're thinking great taste in a less filling beer, Miller Lite's everything you want a beer to be.
No. We don't come here often.
Starting now, your photos have the power of television. Introducing the Kodak Photo CD.
You won't believe your heart. You won't believe your eyes.
Your pictures taken with your current film and camera, transferred onto a new kind of compact disc and shown on TV. The special Photo CD player also plays audio CDs.
Your pictures have never been so powerful.
The new Kodak Photo CD system. You've got to see it.
This game summary is sponsored by Kodak Photo CD System.
To summarize, Steve Young, 109 yards passing, 46 rushing. Rice, 64th postseason reception, is a new team record. The Redskins' 3 points came as a result of a turnover. A fumble by Young. They have it first and 10 at their own 24. 49ers leading 10-3, 11:59 left in the first half. That's Brian Mitchell. Two about the 30. And a 6-yard pickup as Dana Hall came up to lead the 49er tackler.
Yeah, Brian Mitchell had such a big game last week against the Minnesota Vikings. He had been primarily a special teams guy, a punt returner, kick returner, cover guy, and had only carried the ball 6 or 7 times during the game. And they brought him in last week as a running back, and he had a big, big day against the Vikings, and he said it was one of the most fun games that he's ever had in a football game in his life.
That's Mitchell again, hit by Whitmore. A loss of a yard.
But Mitchell went to college. He went to Southwest Louisiana, where he was a quarterback, but he said he was a running quarterback, so he was used to running all his life. And of course, it's tough to run when you don't have any lane like that. And anytime you see a safety like David Whitmore was up there on the line of scrimmage or in the backfield, that means that they're using 8 men against your run.
Third down. They need about five. Ripon back to throw. And time to do it. More than enough for the first down to Sanders. Outside the 40. 11-yard gain stopped by Griffin.
Ricky Sanders was one of the first guys out on the field today, and it was interesting. He just came out here in a pair of shorts and his shoes on, and he was trying the field because he knew it was going to be a problem. And I've always felt in a sloppy or heavy field that the offense has the advantage. You know, not the home team or visiting team, but the offense, because they know where they're going and the defense has to adjust to it.
Fake to Mitchell. Clark runs into the 49ers safety man, who is Dana Hall. And if there's going to be any sort of flag, it's going to be called against Gary Clark because he ran into Hall.
Well, you see, number 28 is Hall, the rookie free safety. He has the position. He starts to slide. And as you say, if there's anything to call, which I don't think they should call anything, but it would have been on Gary Clark, Hall was stumbling into a position, and Gary Clark just pushed him from behind.
Second and 10, Ripon's 4 out of 7. 9:59 left to play in the second quarter as it begins to rain. Not heavily yet. Ripon to Mitchell to about the 46. Stopped by Walter. A gain of 5. Out come the umbrellas and the jackets.
Yeah, but you can't bring an umbrella. It ought to be a rule. You can't bring an umbrella to a football game. I mean, look at the guy in the middle. The guy has an umbrella. How's the guy behind him see? Put your gear on.
What about the people next to him? Yeah. What about their eyes?
Well, the other one has an umbrella next to him. What happened to football? You just come out and you play in the weather and you fan in the weather. No, right. Ought to be a rule. You can never bring an umbrella to a ball game.
It's a good rule. Let's go to the league meeting. Griffin pass deflected, intended for Sanders. Knocked away by Eric Davis.
The weather, the areas that we talked about earlier, that if the 49ers have had a weakness this year, it's been the secondary. You know, people have been able to work on their corners, Eric Davis, Merton Hanks, their two safeties, Whitmore and Dana Hall. But again, you know, they play just well enough that you may get some plays, but you're not going to get a whole lot of plays. And if you don't, then their offense just slices you up.
Kelly Goodburn back to punt. Alan Grant deep. Goodburn left it on the ground. Pass thrown up field. Redskins are saying, we got the ball.
Because that's on their sideline.
Yep. More than likely, they have to have a lineman downfield.
You would think so, but I don't see a flag. Oh, yes, there is a flag.
Yep,
there's a flag down on this side of the field. As you say, anytime there's a play where it's broken and it takes that much time, there's going to be an ineligible man down the field. You just know it has to be. You don't know who it is, but you know it has to be.
Unless the punt receiving team has done a heck of a job on the outside and not letting those guys get downfield. Brett Cashin will let us know.
But by the time, I mean, that took so long, by that time the inside guys felt that they have to go because they usually don't look back. They usually count 1,001, 1,002, 1,003, then they go. And that's one of the things you're always taught is when you're going down on punt coverage, never look back.
That applies to a lot of things.
The other thing you're taught is you only want to hear one thump. That ball just goes right through Goodburn's hands. I mean, he just sticks out his hands, the ball hits him in the thumb. One official is saying that it was a catch.
There is no infraction on the play. We do have a catch. It's a first down.
Yeah, well, it was a catch.
Yeah, it was a catch, but we just assumed that there would be someone at downfield illegally. But I guess they didn't have that. Goodburn makes a heck of a play, if you can call that a heck of a play. I mean, it looks like he just threw it up for grabs in the middle of a crowd.
Johnny Thomas came down.
Johnny Thomas made an amazing play. You talk about a heck of a play. That was a heck of a play. I still can't believe there's no one downfield. Look at that. He's double teamed. He's fallen down, and he comes up with the ball.
Amazing. First down, Redskins in 49er territory. Four wide receivers. Griffin will throw it. Over the head of Ricky Sanders. Incomplete. Nice smiling.
Yeah, I think that's all. When you're Kelly Goodburn and you have a play like that, I think all you can do is laugh about it. You can't take credit for it. There's Thomas, the guy who caught the pass, and I don't believe that he's saying nice pass. Someone's going to give him something there. I think he lost a contact or something. That's probably why he didn't catch the ball.
I thought he was going to shave him.
He's giving him a contact. Oh. No wonder the guy couldn't see. He lost his contact popped out.
Griffin underthrows Sanders again. Eric Davis. Mark Griffin was saying last night that if it is wet and if it does start to rain, you have to loosen your grip on the football. That one might have been tipped at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, I think Mark Griffin has a lot of balls tipped at the line of scrimmage, and he has a lot of balls that do come out differently. That one came out on a spiral, and it was tipped by Ted Washington, number 97.
Third and 10. Griffin back. That's going to be just out of the reach of Derek Clark, and he had a step.
You know, last night we were talking to Gary Clark, and he says the ground has been beating the heck out of him. He said he's really been getting hit, hitting the ground. And he said, what can I do about it? And I said, don't leave your feet. Just run through it. And I think here, if he runs through that, he catches that ball. He didn't have to stop running in order to die. And then, of course, he wouldn't get bounced around like that by the ground. But that's a good look, though, with the mouthpiece out. You got the stuff here. You got the mouthpiece flying out. You got all the mud here and here. I'll tell you, that's not a bad look.
That picture alone just might have gotten him on the All-Madden team.
He's always on that team.
Bearcats signal. The ball heads down toward the end zone. It's going to be down at about the one-foot line by the Redskins. Johnny Thomas is number 41. He was down there to bat it backwards.
At Prudential Securities, we invest the time it takes to get to know you. We invest over $100,000 in training every new financial advisor who serves you. And we invest millions of dollars every year in the research and analysis that helps serve you better. Because at Prudential Securities, the most important thing we have to earn is your trust.
My dad used to say, a man who said he never had a chance never took a chance. When you're in a restaurant, you have to try new things. You got to experiment, and you can't take the safe road. You have to look at what it takes to make the customer number one. I think American Express customers overall are by far the higher profile customer for fine dining. I've been a member since 1962. One of the originals, I think.
American Express is welcomed at the Sardine Factory and other fishy places.
Imagine a rent-a-car company that offers special delivery right to your door. That's Enterprise.
Here, let me help you.
Enterprise, a special rent-a-car company that gives you special delivery.
Are you getting the return you'll need on your retirement savings? Perhaps the one thing worse than dying is outliving your money. Call Prudential Securities.
Follow number one ranked Duke as they try to topple two top 10 foes. Sunday, number 10 Georgia Tech. Next Saturday, number 8 Iowa. Only on CBS Sports.
Candlestick Park in San Francisco. Here's the Redskin punt.
You know, Alvoid Mays is the first guy, number 20 there. He makes a heck of a play by getting it out. Thomas is underneath it, but he doesn't recover. Thomas knows if he recovers it, his knee was on the line. So it was the next man up that recovered that ball. Or down that ball, didn't recover it because it was covering a punt. But that was a smart play, and that's one thing. You know, both these teams have one thing in common. They have very smart players. And that was a very smart play by Johnny Thomas, who made the catch on the broken punt play to not get on that ball because he was on the line.
Young trying to get some room, gets out to about the two. Jason Buck, the man who stopped him.
Now the 49ers are, you know, having some trouble here and bad field position. But if you look, Steve Young being left-handed, and I had the feeling, and I think the Redskins have the feeling, that he does most of his stuff to the left side of the field. He's 8 out of 9 passing to the left side, only 1 out of 2 passing right. So all his successful passes today have been to the left.
Second and 8. Young retreats the throw in the end zone, gets it outside to Waters, and he'll get some more room. And a first down out of bounds at about the 15 by A.J. Johnson. 12-yard pickup.
We were talking to the Redskins last night, and Richard Pettibone was saying that they're, you know, so difficult to really get a beat on. I think having that 15-play script helps that. But again, Steve Young, you see him, he puts Waters out here to the left, knows that if he can get the ball to Ricky Waters, Ricky Waters can make tacklers miss, and he can get first down.
One thing the 49ers are not is predictable, as Richard Pettibone was saying last night. You just don't know. To the 20.
And again, I think that's probably the advantage of a guy like Mike Shanahan, the script in the first 15 plays, because you know what you've done the past weeks, and you can script your first 15 plays to not be predictable. But then I think if you were going to get predictable, you would probably do it after the script ran out, which is this part of the game.
Second and 6. Rushing yards, the 49ers have 70 to 20. For the Redskins. First down here. Second down, beg your pardon. Young to throw it. That's out of bounds. Rice was out of bounds, the intended receiver.
You know, Jerry Rice is one of those guys that believes that if you're going to play well, and I have never heard this by any other player in the National Football League, but you got to look good. And he spends his whole time on how he looked. I mean, he polishes his helmet. His jersey has to be just right. His pants are taped to the jersey so the shirt tail doesn't come out. He has the gloves. He has those things on there, those wristbands. The socks have to be perfectly new and white. Everything has to be perfect before he steps on that field.
Third down. That's Taylor, who keeps both feet in bounds and picks up 13 yards and a first down.
You know, we were talking to Steve Young yesterday. He said that he feels that for the first time this week, John Taylor is back. You know, that he's been such a big part of this offense. He broke his leg going across the middle in the middle of the season, came back here at the end of the season and wasn't really 100%. But both Steve Young and George Seifert felt that John Taylor is looking the best right now than he has since his injury.
Rice in motion. On the water. Left side for a couple, maybe 3 yards.
He was doing a pretty good job down there as Harris Barton, the right tackle of the 49ers. He's made the Pro Bowl this year, but he's been out 3 weeks with a bad knee. You watch him right here. He's going to be blocking against Charles Mann. Mann also has a bad knee. So you kind of see two guys that have been playing all year and are pretty beat up, and that's about what you get in a playoff game.
A standoff.
But I like Harris Barton. I mean, he's probably the, you know, if you could measure worry wart, he would be the number one worry wart in the NFL.
Young to right. Out of bounds by A.J. Johnson. First down. 5:24 left to play in the first half. 10-3. 49ers leading the Redskins.
But Jerry Rice is one of those players that you always want to get the ball too early, get him involved in the game. And of course, Steve Young has done that. You know, his first pass of the game, he threw it to Jerry Rice. He kept him involved in the first quarter, kept him involved in the second quarter. And when Jerry Rice has 4 passes already, then they have him involved.
The more he gets involved, the better he gets. Young to Waters on the trap play. Ricky Waters barrels down into Redskin territory after a gain of 21 yards.
Boy, did he hit that hole. You're going to talk about a trap. Let's just watch this play here. We'll see it come across. The trap is right there. You see Govea is going to come up 54, hits the hole. Here comes the trap. Boom, you just knock him out right there. There goes Ricky Waters right inside that trap play. Guy McIntyre was the left guard. He came across the trap. He's going to pick up Govea. Boom, right there. That creates a hole. Ricky Waters hits it quickly, then makes a heck of a move.
Young to Waters. Again, flashes briefly into the Redskins secondary down at the 30, a gain of four. Remember, this all started at about the 1 foot line with Young's quarterback sneak. Now they're at the Redskin 29.
Yeah, and I think, you know, Waters running to Pasadena, of course, is talking about the Super Bowl. I think that, you know, maybe at the end of the season, you have to say that Steve Young has been the biggest surprise of the 49ers, you know, making the MVP in the league and all that stuff. But I think the biggest surprise to me was Ricky Waters, how good a player he is and what a contribution he's made this year.
They is what they thought he might be when they drafted him. Young going deep. Pass intercepted at about the 5 by A.J. Johnson. This one did not go through his hands.
And I'll tell you, that's Young should hit both sides of his head on that one. He was rolling to the right, which he usually doesn't do. He was throwing back, which he usually doesn't do. And he was throwing right to a guy in the other color jersey. Watch him. He usually goes to the left. Now he's rolling out right, which is tough to do. Now he has to step and throw back. And his guy isn't even open. He throws it right to them.
Too much air under that pass.
In one day,
we send out a lot of packages.
Probably ship maybe
5 packages a day.
30 packages.
200 packages a day by United Parcel.
They do a good job.
2,000 to 3,000.
3,000 to 4,000.
That's a lot of packages.
So we ship it overnight.
To Chicago.
Florida.
Atlanta.
Overseas.
Belgium.
Italy.
Venezuela.
On the ground.
Second day air.
Second day air.
Off it goes.
Next day.
10:30 guaranteed.
Guaranteed.
Only one company does all that.
UPS.
UPS?
I would think UPS.
UPS does everything.
It's from A to Z. Nuts to soup.
There's nothing else like it on Earth, or maybe even in heaven. It stretches for 725 miles, and it's called the California Coastline. There are over 4 million miles of roads in Alamo Territory, all across America. And every day, with every car nationwide, only Alamo gives you all those miles for free, including the ones where the people bask in the sun and watch the seals, and the seals bask in the sun and watch the people.
There's a reason more people go to Sears for a new battery.
Can't believe I left my lights on.
Only Sears has the DieHard. Sears is so confident of DieHard starting power, if you need a jump, Sears will do it absolutely free. Anytime, anywhere, even if you leave your lights on.
Got stranded once, never again.
You can count on
DieHard.
Me.
More power when you need it most.
Ruth Ann claims her independence and buys the store from Maurice.
I'll never set foot in this quarry again.
You pompous old goat!
All new Northern Exposure Monday.
3:28 left to play in the first half at Candlestick. The 49ers 10, the Redskins 3. Ripping and the Redskins start from the 5. First and 10. Brian Mitchell struggles to about the 12, got a yard, maybe two. Kevin Fagan on the tackle. Jerry Rice even looks neat standing there.
Well, yeah, and he does it properly. He's talking to Joe Montana. They're, of course, a guy, Jerry Rice, has the all-time record, and a guy that helped him get that all-time record is Joe Montana, one of the best who ever played this game.
If not the best.
How's that?
Great! I like to use the bathroom.
You got it.
I always tell my customers, be sure to take your credit card receipts. I should have listened to myself. The other day I got a call from Citibank. Somebody charged some pretty fancy stuff on my card number. Citibank suspected fraud, but they said I wouldn't be responsible for the charges.
I've seen Citibank look out for my customers. Seems they're also looking out for me.
Not just Visa, Citibank Visa.
Here's Alka-Seltzer Plus fights tough colds with tough congestion, tough aches,
tough sore throat.
This is why you need a tough medicine. Alka-Seltzer Plus Cold Medicine. The leading cold pill only relieves congestion, but Alka-Seltzer Plus relieves congestion, sore throat, sneezing, body aches. That's tough medicine.
You bet it's tough.
Alka-Seltzer Plus Cold Medicine. It's tough medicine. For a cold with a cough, try Alka-Seltzer Plus Cold and Cough Medicine.
I've had a Toyota pickup for 6 years, and I love it. It's the fact that I need a bigger truck. And I told them in my letter that I'd like a bigger size truck. They brought it down. They said, here, take a look at this, see what you think.
Here it comes.
Pretty cool, huh?
Hey, guys, come here.
At first, you know, I had my doubts that we were all going to get in here comfortably.
Roomy, huh?
Yeah, it's roomy.
Hello, 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 hello.
It's roomy. That's
a Introducing the Toyota T100, the answer to the big question.
Tomorrow at 12 o'clock Eastern, round three of the battle between Philadelphia and Dallas, but this time the winner advances to the NFC Championship next week. The Eagles won their first playoff game in 12 years against the Saints last Sunday as they erased a 13-point second-half deficit. Tomorrow they'll travel to Dallas to take on the Cowboys for the third time this season. They split the two regular season games. It starts at 12 o'clock Eastern with the NFL Today. Right now, Griffin hits Monk about a foot shy of that first down.
Boy, did they have a cushion over on that side. Eric Davis was on that corner. The 49ers play a lot of zone defense, and it was to the wide side of the field. They didn't get any underneath help at all. And watch how much room that Art Monk has on this side. If we can just look and stop it now, we see that what happens is Eric Davis runs here, and that's what allows this cushion there. Then Mark Griffin sees that, and that allows a 7-yard cushion.
Third and short. Hand off to Biner. First down, Redskins. 12-yard gain. Don Griffin had to make the stop, and the Redskins buy a little breathing room.
And that's the thing that the Redskins want to do. They wanted time of possession, keep the 49er offense off the field. They wanted turnovers. They just got that before this. They wanted to be able to control the ball and then, of course, you know, make some plays as they go on.
Right now, they want to get a play run. Well, no, they don't. Timeout 49ers. Not a Redskin timeout. They have one left, San Francisco does. Griffin heads for the sideline to talk with head coach Joe Gibbs and company.
Outlaw. Lover. Hero. Van Damme, as you've never seen him before. Nowhere to Run, rated R, at theaters Friday.
Hey, I'm vain. Of course I'm vain. That's why I comb my hair the way I do. I stay in shape the way I do. That's why I use Power Stick.
50% more wetness and odor fighters per stroke. Power Stick by Fabergé. Power that won't let you down.
I told you I was vain.
Back at Candlestick, 2:21 left to play in the first half. 49ers 10, Redskins 3. Washington ball first down at their own 26. Joe Gibbs, he seemed, I thought, unusually relaxed and enthusiastic last night.
Yeah, the first thing he came, he had a smile on his face, came in the room, just got off the airplane and said, they're calling this game Mission Impossible.
Ripping down by Tim Harris. And out come the six guns.
Tim Harris said, you know, earlier in the season, he got penalized for doing this. And here's Tim Harris right up here. We'll see him working on Big Ed Simmons. And he's just going to go into him, start like a bull rush, and then make an inside move on him. Simmons moved his left leg out of there. Anytime a tackle takes his left leg out there, he gives the inside. And Harris says he can do the six gun as long as he doesn't do it towards a quarterback or the other team.
So it doesn't look like he is taunting the people that he just defeated.
Why would anyone stay in a place where the night lasts for 6 months?
Come on!
Let me show you where it's at.
Come on!
Let me show you where it's at.
Come on!
Let me show you where it's at.
Hey, Jay.
Got a couple of cold ones?
Hey, guys. It's the Arctic.
Cold Miller Lite. I like it like that.
Great taste in a less filling beer is pretty important, especially when you have a long evening in front of you.
Working nights is gonna kill me.
Miller Lite, it's everything you want a beer to be.
When you rent a car from Hertz, you get more than free unlimited mileage. You get the company behind the car, so that the miles aren't just free, they're worry-free. And since Hertz can give you rates this low, there's no better way to get up and go. Now, with all those free miles ahead of you, wouldn't you feel better with Hertz behind you?
Hertz, we're America's wheels.
Imagine you're 2 inches tall, and you're walking by these two delicious Big Mac sandwiches. Pretty big, huh? Then you see the price. Two for $2. Pretty small, huh? Of course, the hard part would be reaching the counter. You see, because you're 2 inches tall, and it'd be a Now McDonald's has two Egg McMuffin sandwiches for just $2. Due to incredible demand, we're forced to use this mirror to simulate what a second one would look like.
What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
No, I think this is your best side.
Coming up on the NFL Today Halftime Report, Greg Terry, Randy Cross, and Mike Ditka will analyze the first half and get you caught up on all the day's playoff news. That's coming up at the half. Going to be second at 16 for the Redskins.
Glenn Ditko will probably say the 49ers should have ran more when they threw those interceptions. They shouldn't be throwing the ball then.
There's a reverse to Monk. A lot of people waiting. As Monk had to cut it all the way back and is stopped by Martin Harrison.
You see Dennis Brown, big number 96, he had two shots at him. Watch 96. I mean, he's a big old 300-pound guy. Boom, right there he misses him. And then he's going to get up, and Monk is going to come back. Now watch 96 is going to go boom, right there he misses him again. He gets blocked, and they finally get him down. So Dennis Brown is saying, hey, the guy went by me once, I'm still hanging around it, and he went by me the other time.
And somebody blocked me again. Third and 13. Griffin across the middle. That's shaky as to whether or not it's a first down, and shaky as to whose ball it is. San Francisco.
I think you're right, Pat. That's a 49er ball.
Dana Whitmore came up with it. Let's see.
Yeah, see, the ball came out. Yeah. His knee didn't hit. He wasn't down. There was no ground or anything. He was up in the air, and that ball came out while he was in the air. That's a 49er ball. You said David Whitmore, he just took it and brought it over here. That's what everyone does. That's a new thing. You notice that? The guy gets a ball, no matter what the play is, gives it to the equipment man. That's Bronco, the 49er equipment right. guy. Then the equipment man puts it in some box, and then you have no idea what happens to him after the game.
Well, they know they're going to get some TV time. That's for sure. Outside the Ricky Waters. Had to spin around backwards, almost made a one-handed catch. Jumpy Gathers is getting a little jumpy.
That's Roy Foster in there, you know, who has really done a good job for this 49er offensive line. You know about Barton and Wallace. They're both in the Pro Bowl. But the middle of this line of the 49ers, Roy Foster at the right guard and Jesse Sapolo, the center. Now, they don't talk much about those guys, but they've been very steady, very good players. See, Steve Young is pretty smart for a quarterback. If you go down and you're on your back, the big guys are fighting over the top of you, get your foot up where you can kick them. You see him?
Yep.
Huh? You got the Brogan up there. Always put a Brogan in the air. Big guys are fighting above you.
Young to Rathman. He was hit just as he made the reception. Gets to the 30, a gain of 5. Stopped by Stokes. Less than a minute now. 47 seconds. Young calls a timeout. That's all for San Francisco.
Yeah, that's one of the problems where the quarterback doesn't call his own plays and things are scripted and plays are sent in. You get to a point where you're trying to save timeout, you're trying to call the plays on the field, and you just don't have the tools to do it.
There is Steve Bono, Joe Montana. Boy, a lot of teams would like to have any one of those three quarterbacks.
Yep, and they're all in a line. The Joe Montana, of course, if something were to happen to Steve Young, and I think that's the only way he would play in this game, would be the backup quarterback. He's in this game as a number two quarterback. Steve Bono is in this game as a number three quarterback, but more importantly than that, he's the holder for the extra point and field goal. They only went with two quarterbacks. It would have been Joe Montana, then he would have had a hold.
You know, it's amazing, we'll get into this later, how superstition is a part of sports. Yesterday, we were talking to George Seifert. You asked him what were some of his superstitions, and he just sort of backed off and said, I'm not going to tell you.
A part of being superstitious is you don't talk about it.
To Brent Jones, first down, 49ers, a gain of 14.
And again, the 49ers have no timeouts now, so they have to make this no huddle work. He didn't do that very well.
No, he didn't.
What he was trying to do was pull out, throw the ball down, and stop the clock.
He wound up slamming with both hands.
I know. It looked like, I mean, it was close to being a fumble. You got to watch out. You got to, you know, take that ball, then bring it back, and then throw it down. That looked like it was all one action from the snap to going down. Just watch it as it comes out of here. He just gets that ball. No, he did okay. He just threw it down with two hands.
30 seconds left. You got to have your field goal team ready with no timeouts. No flag. Here's Young. Touchdown. Boy, you can't give him much room.
Steve Young has to be the happiest guy there because he threw the interception on the time before. Then the defense went out there. They got the fumble recovery from Brian Mitchell, and Steve Young got his chance again. Watch him. He moves the ball around. You know about Jerry Rice. You know about John Taylor. You also know, watch 84-90 down here. The closer you get to the goal line, the more he looks for Brent Jones. I tell you, Brent Jones fumbled that into the end zone. And he's talking about, I wonder if that was a completion.
Well, he might have. If he did, if the pass was complete, he might have fumbled and recovered his own fumble.
Yeah.
They talk about him. You look at, watch him run whatever patterns they are. Watch it again.
Of course, when you get down there, you know, you're always looking for that tight end anyway. He did catch a pass. That was a catch because he caught the ball, came down with both feet. Then he has the ball. Then as he goes in, he fumbles. Now, it is a fumble. So it's not a touchdown until now when he recovers it.
He recovers it.
So that was a throw, a catch, a fumble recovery for a touchdown.
But I started to say a minute ago, this guy, Brent Jones, they say he has a great feel for the passing game. He doesn't run much of a pattern. Watch this.
Well, again, they don't have to. If you just watch the tight end, when he comes down, he'll just be in the middle. And if we could just come down here and just let it go, and then we'll see where he stops in his zone defense. We stop it right now. You see how the defense all kind of comes around here and just leaves him open in the middle of the defense. And usually in any type of zone defense or double coverage or any of that, usually the guy that will be open is the tight end in the middle of the field.
But he's got to know where to stop in that zone.
Yeah, right. And there's the other tight end, Jamie Williams. He's the backup tight end. He's the slower of the two. Brent Jones is the receiver, the faster of the two tight ends. And Jamie Williams is a blocker. And he caught Jamie Williams holding one time today, and he gets upset when I say that, but he's the slower of the two.
He's going to be sorry to hear you said that.
He says if he ever scores a touchdown on a big pass, he wants silence from this booth.
No comment from the booth. Mitchell at the goal line. Brian Mitchell to about the 22. Clock still running with 15 seconds left. Again, a reminder that coming up at the half, the NFL today with Greg and Terry, Randy Cross, and Mike Ditka. and playoff news and other news around the NFL. That's coming up on the NFL Today at the half.
And one thing Randy Cross is going to say, I told you those 49ers were that good. Mike Ditka is going to say, when you have the ball and it's in the last 2 minutes and you're going, you can't be diving over a play and letting the ball go. You have to control the ball.
Here's Rippon. Over the middle to Clark. 42. They might get one more play. Thane Gash and Merton Hanks stopped him. Timeout Redskins. They will get another play.
Remember last week there was that picture of Gary Clark and Joe Gibbs jawing each other in the sideline, and what Joe Gibbs says was that Gary Clark has tantrums. I mean, he's just one of those guys that is a competitor, and he just comes over in the sideline and starts yelling at everything, and Gibbs told him, calm down, because you know if you have a temper tantrum early in the game, then you drop balls in the second half. Well, that set Gary Clark off again. He said, What do you mean drop balls? You don't have any confidence in me. So Joe Gibbs says, yeah, I do have confidence with you. So then they had a meeting and stuff and the couch and all that stuff, and everything is back to normal. But Gary Clark is Gary Clark, and Joe Gibbs is Joe Gibbs.
And it's hard to say it's back to normal with Gary Clark, because he always wants the ball, and he's always going to let you know about it. Griffin gives it to Beiner. Beiner's going to run out of bounds with 1 second left on the clock. 1 second left in the first half. 17-3, the 49ers leading. That was a gain of 21.
You still have to say that this is probably the best coaching staff in the National Football League. They've been together so long, Joe Gibbs and the rest of his staff, and, you know, and what they've done and accomplished over the years, has really been remarkable. And he's done it as a gentleman. I mean, he's done it as a very bright guy and a very good coach, and he's been good for the game of football.
He's been good for everybody he's associated with.
Yeah, he's made everything better.
Rippon's going to throw it up as high as he can, as far as he can. That's going to mean it's in the end zone and out. Almost caught on the rebound by Art Monk. That is the end of the first half with the score, the 49ers 17, the Redskins 3.
CBS Sports coverage of the National Football Conference Divisional Playoff is sponsored by McDonald's. What you want is what you get, guaranteed at McDonald's today. Miller Lite, an official sponsor of the NFL and Super Bowl 27. And by Hertz, the people's choice in rent-a-car for 75 years.
Every week, the NFL rocks.
Hurry it up.
You better hurry.
This message furnished by the National Football League.
I drove it for 8 years.
Your Toyota dealer invites you to see the all-new Corolla.
I never got so much out of a car.
And discover a special lease program that makes getting a new Corolla easier than ever.
But I've gone on to bigger and better things. Just got the new one.
For as little as $179 a month with no money down, you get more room, more comfort, and more safety features. A great car becomes a great deal. Discover the new Corolla lease program at your Toyota dealer and rediscover value.
Stagecoach funds have arrived. Mutual funds for investors more comfortable on Main Street than Wall Street.
They're here!
11 different funds, from tax-free income to government securities to long-term capital growth, all aimed at helping you get where you're going. Stagecoach Funds, now available at every Wells Fargo office. Climb aboard.
Italy.
The Chevy Lumina comes with the protection of a 3-year, 36,000-mile bumper-to-bumper, no-deductible warranty and a 24-hour roadside assistance program. And is available with anti-lock brakes. But even all that can't protect you from every hazard on the road.
The NFL Today Dockers Halftime Report is sponsored by Levi's Dockers. Nobody does color like Dockers.
And welcome back to our studios here in New York, everyone. Greg Gumbel along with Terry Bradshaw and Randy Cross. Halftime of the game at Candlestick Park with the 49ers with a 17-3 lead on the Washington Redskins. On the NFL Today pregame show, we talked about how the Redskin defense never embarrasses itself, and were it not for a late touchdown by the 49ers, this would still be a very tight game.
Well, it would, Greg, and, you know, right now it's still a close enough game, but if you flip it over and you look at the Redskins' offense, really third down conversions have been very poor. They've only 3 for 8. They have only 150 yards in total offense. They had the big shot to Clark, the touchdown pass, missed that. Not running the football, so when they run the football, Rippon's better, but right now they're not. The 49ers plainly have taken it away from them.
Yes, and the 49ers, I think you will admit, Randy, have been very fortunate, especially on that first touchdown.
Well, they should have had three turnovers with that first touchdown, but you look at the game right now, you look at two things, as far as I'm concerned. Richie Pettibone and that defensive staff have to make things happen. They got to take some chances. And Mark Rippon's having his worst nightmare. He's facing a pretty good defense. He's going to have to throw the ball, and he's going to put that thing up for grabs.
Steve Young, 2 touchdown passes, 1 to John Taylor, 1 to Brent Jones, 17-3. And let's take it back now to Bannockburn, Illinois, where Mike Ditka is standing by after having watched the first half. Coach, you know very well Joe Gibbs' record in the postseason, his ability to adjust, and that's what it's all about in the National Football League. What kind of changes would you expect Joe Gibbs to be making for the second half?
Well, I think what you guys emphasize is true, but I think the key to the game right now is if you really look at what the difference is, it's the 49ers defense. I mean, everybody wants to talk about the 49ers offense all the time. Their defense has shut down the running game, really, and they've played very well, very consistent football. They're putting enough pressure on the quarterback. They're doing the things they have to do. And when you do that, it's going to be very hard to get going. I think they got to get the running game going, and they got to try to put some pressure on the 49er defense by running the football. But whether they can do that or not, I'm not sure.
Mike, this 49er defense hasn't really been the strong point for the team this year. It's been the offense. Would you think that this 49er team, as it is constructed, is good enough to win it all?
I think they're the best team in football balance-wise. I think they do everything they have to do to win. They keep plugging people in where they have a gap or a hole. Somebody gets hurt, they plug somebody in there, and they keep going. Their system is very sound. George has done an excellent job of coaching them. And, I mean, you just can't say enough about the way they can attack you with the offense. They play pretty sound in the special teams. But I think the thing that gets overlooked, and I know they were way down the list in giving up pass yardage this year, but the reason for that is they were ahead of most teams, and most teams had to throw the football on them, and they still ended up winning the majority of the football games, had the best record in football. So when I think you say their defense hasn't been their strong point all year, their defense has been good enough to win 12 games or so, and when you look at that, that's pretty significant.
All right, Mike, we thank you very much for spending time with us today. We wish you all the best.
Thank you.
You bet. Mike Ditka from his home in Bannockburn, Illinois. Now, earlier today, the Buffalo Bills qualified for the AFC Championship game. They will travel either to San Diego or Miami. They beat the Steelers today 24-3. Bill Cowher saw his AFC Central champions fall, and Neil O'Donnell had a tough day.
O'Donnell, a little rusty, sees the safety trying to rotate, tries to force the ball underthrown, and Williams makes the interception. Great.
Meanwhile, Frank Reich continued his role, 2 touchdown passes, including this one to James Lofton. Next week, Jim Kelly or Frank Reich to start? Here's Reich after the game.
It's an awful lot of fun, but obviously I'm paid to perform out in the field, and any decisions that are going to be made with the quarterback obviously are going to be made by Coach Levy, and I respect any decision he makes.
Well, I've said it 100 times. I'm going to say it now for the last time for the world. When Jim Kelly is healthy and can practice during the week, we'll do that, and he'll be our starting quarterback.
That, as they say, is the final word. And this final note, one day after firing head coach Dick McPherson, Sam Jankovic has just announced his resignation as general manager of the New England Patriots. With McPherson and now Jankovic gone, it would appear that owner James Orthwine could be closer to selling the team, a sale that would keep the Patriots in the New England area. 49ers lead at 17-3 at halftime. Take a timeout here and then rejoin Pat and John out at Candlestick after this word from your local station.
When
When Raven baits a killer...
Kiss me.
He could get caught in his own trap.
What's she doing with the gun?
She's pointing it at us.
Raven, wanted for murder. Then, the war on drugs...
Just say no.
...goes to the dogs...
I think you found something big.
...to rescue a kidnapped brother.
I love to live dangerously.
The Hat Squad after Raven tonight. A cop and his wife thought they'd be safe in a suburban complex. Instead, they found a nightmare.
He raped me.
My wife could be next.
Complex of Fear, Tuesday. This is CBS. If you want to see more features, turn to a movie channel. See the ES300 at your Northern California Lexus dealer. You'll like the price of admission.
I suppose getting older has its drawbacks. Your hair starts to get thin. You can't stay up for the late show. And spicy foods, forget them. But it's not all bad. When you turn 55, Great Western will give you a checking account with no monthly service charges. That'll save you money. It'll make you feel good. So if you're 55, talk to Great Western Bank. They've got lots of ways to save on checking. I'm going to do it in about 10 years.
The experience of buying a $60,000 car is, to say the least, different. You get to walk around a showroom without looking over your shoulder. Nobody makes you have a conversation you really don't want to have. And you're given all the time you need to make your decision. It's a pretty nice way to shop for an automobile. And it feels even better when the car you're looking at costs around $13,000.
The Warriors beat the Pistons today at 4:30 on Channel 5.
Halftime at Candlestick. The 49ers 17, the Redskins 3. Right now, let's send you down to the field and Pat O'Brien.
Right on the field, Pat Summerall, and you can see it's looking pretty terrible, but Steve Young tells me the field is not bothering him at all. I asked him, what about the couple of turnovers? He says, Pat, it's 17-3. Those turnovers aren't bothering me either. The Redskins are angry, a couple of missed opportunities there. They're talking about that they need a whole lot more poise on offense, and Rod Dauhauer, the assistant coach, says he hopes this is one of those games that Mark Rippon starts slow and ends quickly. They also remind themselves that the Eagles were down 17-3 just a week ago now. Let's go back upstairs to Pat Summerall.
All right. With me, of course, John Madden. Steve Young has been able, it seems to me, to do just about whatever he wants to. He seems to be the key.
Yeah, and I think so, because the Redskins really haven't stopped the 49ers yet. The 49ers stopped themselves a couple times, and the 49ers in the first half didn't have to punt one time, so that means that the Redskin defense really isn't forcing anything. I think somewhere along the way they're going to have to force and maybe start to blitz some more and maybe take some chances. The other thing is they haven't been able to stop the run. I know that anytime you talk about Joe Gibbs or talk to Joe Gibbs, he says the two things we have to do is be able to run and stop the run. They've only run for 36 yards in the first half. The 49ers have run for 98. So they've lost both of those areas.
One of the things they said was, if we can run for 120 yards, 125 yards, we can win. They haven't been able to do that. 17-3, the 49ers over the Redskins at the half.
Dean Witter believes every investor's success story is unique. From getting in on the ground floor to getting all the way to the top, Dean Witter can help you make it every step of the way.
We measure success one investor at a time.
Our 6-inch meatball sub features meatballs and sauce on bread I just baked, all for a low economical price. I won't say how low, but you'll probably find enough in the cushions of your couch.
The 6-inch meatball sub, only $1.69, only at Subway.
Monday Night Football's over, so get in on the jokes. When Audrey's ex-lover returns, watch out for Macho Miles.
And if he hadn't been wearing that heavy sweater, he might actually have felt it.
All new Murphy Brown. Then meet the food critic with an attitude.
I gave him a glass I used to gargle with.
All new Love and War, Monday.
All those who love great comedy say aye.
When no one can hear you scream, you've still got one more chance.
I thought you'd come out here to check out the good restaurants.
Wednesday, Space Rangers.
CBS Sports coverage of the National Football Conference Divisional Playoff is sponsored by Honda, celebrating its 10th anniversary of automobile production in the United States. The ingenious products from Magnavox, they're smart, very smart. And by AT&T, the right choice.
Joe Montana loosening up. Don't expect him to play unless young Steve Young gets hurt. And you, of course, hope that doesn't happen.
You know, Pat, we just got a report that we lost an official to a leg injury. Headlinesman Sanford Rivers is out, and he's going to replace. They have an alternate official in these playoff games, and Sid Seaman will replace him. There's Sid Seaman right there. He's loosening up. He was on the sideline in the first half, and now he's going to be in the game in the second half.
Hofer set to kick off, or getting set to kick off. Whoop. Brian Mitchell back deep for the Redskins. 17-3. The 49ers on top. They've just about been unstoppable in the first half. As John Madden mentioned a moment ago, they haven't had to punt yet.
And again, I think that's because they've been able to move the ball around. They've been able to run their offense. They've had almost 100 yards in rushing. As I said, the Redskins haven't been able to stop the run, nor have they been able to run offensively.
Mitchell, the two. To the 26, perhaps. Halftime statistics. 49ers 14 first downs, 60 more yards passing, 60 more yards running, more time of possession. They own the first half.
And I think the big thing when you talk about the Redskins, I think, is right here, only running for 36 and giving up 98. Because every time they play, the run is the thing that they base everything they do on,
including success and win.
And defending Super Bowl championships.
Rippon back to throw. Gets it off the field. Clark. Redskin first down. Whitmore made the stop. Washington's first half possession resulted in a punt. Their points. Another punt. A fumble.
And the thing is, when you only have 8 first downs like they did, that means that you haven't really knit a lot of things together. So there's going to be a lot of things. Well, they should have done this, they should have done that, but you didn't have the ball in enough plays to do a whole lot of things. But the Redskins do make great adjustments at halftime. I think better than anyone else.
Remember what they did to Minnesota in the second half last week. Intended for Monk. Harris put the pressure on Rippon.
You know, Rippon has a pretty clean jersey, though. And, you know, and talking to Tim Harris yesterday, he was saying that they feel that you have to knock Rippon down. You know, that you can't let him stand in there and be comfortable. And even though you don't get a sack, in fact, Tim Harris said, even if we have to take a 15-yard penalty, we feel that we got to knock him down. And if you look at this first half, they really didn't knock Rippon down much. And if you look at his jersey, that kind of proves it.
Back to throw again. For the green spot. Maybe he had Sanders in mind, but it was in the back of his mind.
You know, if you look at the first half, Mark Rippon, he was sacked twice, hurried 3 times, and they only did knock him down 1 time.
But they say you can't, as you mentioned, they can't let him get comfortable back there.
Yeah,
that's what he hurt you.
I don't think he's gotten very comfortable back there. Right there, he saw the rush. Did you see that?
Yeah.
He was looking downfield, and you shouldn't do that. He took his eyes off downfield, and he looked at number 78, Pierce Holt, looked right down at him, and then came up and had to try and throw it.
3rd and 10. Back to throw it again. Stepped up. Pass behind is intercepted by Eric Davis. Pierce Holt put the pressure on him.
I think so. I think you have to give the interception to Eric Davis. You give the interception to Eric Davis, but you have to give a little part of that to Pierce Holt, because he had to see Pierce Holt. Pierce Holt is going to come right up the middle. He's right here. He makes a swim, and he comes right up here. And I'm sure that Mark Rippon feels him and sees him. See that swim move again on Charette? He's right there. He made Rippon step up. In fact, I think as he stepped up, I think he may have tipped that ball a little. Rippon had to bring the ball down, and then look at this. This is the interception. Awfully good coverage. But it all started with the pass rush of...
Here go the 49ers on a reverse to Rice. Rice out of bounds at the Redskin 46. A pickup of 9. Brad Edwards knocked him out of bounds.
I think Pierce Holt has been playing a pretty good game in there today. You know, he's up against Mark Schlereth, and he has a sack, but he's right there in the middle, and I think that he's starting to give Rippon some problems.
It's amazing. He is.
Yeah, he's a guy that, you know, got out of high school and didn't go to college to play football, and for 4 years got married, went to work, decided he wanted to play.
Legally blind in one eye.
Came into professional football late, self-made man.
That trap play again this time. They shut it down. Legally blind in one eye. He has only 10% vision in his right eye.
And that's the thing. And he, you know, so he doesn't see all that stuff from the right on. He says that he can see anything that's coming down from his left. And then he feels instinctively, you know, what's happening to the inside. And that's why he plays the left side. I mean, you can turn your head to the inside, but you have to be able to see out of your left eye for anything that is coming down on you.
First and 10, 49. Young. Another 49er first down, close to the 30. 13-yard gain. Andre Collins made the stop.
See, this is the thing that they could do, is they can control the line of scrimmage here. They can block. They can run the ball. You see Roy Foster, an excellent drive block, a good start. Steve Wallace pulled all the way, couldn't even find. He pulled from the left tackle all the way around, couldn't even find anyone to block for 10 yards. That hole was so big. That was a form of the Redskin counter where the off tackle, Steve Wallace, pulled up through the hole. What, oh, they could have given the ball to Steve Wallace.
121 yards on the ground for the 49ers. Waters again. Not much there. Wilbur Marshall and Andre Collins combined to stop Waters.
You know, there's a name that we haven't heard much today is Wilbur Marshall.
Right.
I think that the 49er game plan has done a good job of keeping Wilbur Marshall out of the plays. He hasn't really been an effect on the pass. He really hasn't had an effect on the run. Part of it has been he's being blocked. Part of it has been they've been staying away from him.
He's had one tackle today.
And that, when you get into third quarter, he's only had one tackle. That's a quiet Wilbur Marshall. He's having his best year.
Second and 8. Williams with the man in motion. From behind, Young gets away from the rush. Pat Taylor being chased by Martin Mayhew. Excuse me.
Watch this. Here's Wilbur Marshall. We're just saying that he hasn't done much against the pass. Here he comes on a blitz. I think the 49ers believe that, too. The running back Waters blocks away. No one blocks Marshall. Steve Young, though, is so strong that he didn't see him coming. Wilbur Marshall had a straight shot at him and still didn't knock him down.
You know, that's one of the things, John, you don't hear much about Steve Young. You know he's left-handed. You know he can run. You know he's got a strong arm, but you don't realize how big and strong he is.
That's right. And you know he's quick and fast, but the other ingredient, like you just said, is strength.
Gerard in motion. This time Steve Young has a lot of time. Gets it out to John Taylor.
There's Darryl Green now. Darryl Green has a heel injury. Remember, he had the broken arm. Didn't play last week because of the heel injury. Thought he would play a little today in nickel, Of course, when you get down, you know, in the third quarter, you're down 17-3. You need everything you have.
Fourth and four, no field goal kicker. They're going to try to put this away. 17-3, 49ers lead with 10:21 left in the third quarter. Fourth and four, and they're going for it.
Yeah, they must believe that Kofor couldn't make it back. They're going to take a timeout because they didn't have the right play, but they have to believe from this distance on this field,
that
Kofor didn't have a good chance of making it.
17-3.
Eighteen years ago, Honda introduced a new class of car to America. The Accord. Now we'd like to introduce a new class of Accord. With fine leather appointments, anti-lock brakes, and dual airbags. The Accord SE from Honda.
In just 45 seconds, this commercial will tell you about all the highly intelligent products from Magnavox. So that means that I have exactly 3.5 seconds to tell you about the ingenious Magnavox 27-inch TV with smart window, leaving me just 5.3 seconds to let you know how incredible this Magnavox CD radio cassette recorder sounds. Oh no, that leaves me only 4.2 seconds to tell you about the brilliant picture on this Magnavox 3-inch LCD TV. I've only got 6.1 seconds to tell you this Magnavox digital shelf system has a carousel CD changer. And I have 1 second to tell you, time is up.
What do you mean, time is up?
What?
We've been standing here for hours. Get my agent on the phone.
Don't you know who I am? Who timed this commercial?
The ingenious products from Magnavox. They're smart, very smart.
Everybody wants a battery that goes the distance, but you never know when they're about to run out of gas. Only Duracell has the Copper Top Battery Tester, so you can be sure your batteries will keep going down the road. You can't top the Copper Top.
They're all guts, all grit, and all glory. They're the ones with the right stuff on and off the field. Ford's ninth annual All-Madden team. That's in 2 weeks. Sunday, January 24th, beginning at 5 Eastern time.
Yep, we're getting that thing ready. Yeah. This isn't a bad feel for it. They're kind of guts and, what was that other word, grit and
glory?
Guts. No glory.
Grit. Yeah.
They got glory. We don't want them.
How about mud?
Yeah, mud, good. Mud, dirt, all that stuff.
A tough team. I'm not sure I'm too part of that.
Oh, yeah, you're part.
Young scrambles for the first down. But a penalty marker down. Darryl Green is applauding, so I would guess it's against San Francisco. Why else would he applaud?
Well, probably because it's going to be against San Francisco, which would probably, if they take the penalty, if they don't take the penalty, it's the first down, so they have to take the penalty.
Yeah.
And that would probably put them in an area where they're going to punt.
Too far for a field goal in a field like this.
Number 67 of the offense. 10 yards,
and they probably can't
down.
Go for it anymore.
I think it's going to be on the 35. They're probably going to have to punt it, as
yeah.
I said. Yeah.
First one of the day.
There's the penalty right there. You saw Roy Foster, number 67, the right guard. He just couldn't make a move to block Darryl Green. After he looks at that 15-yard penalty and have to force the punt, he probably would have been better just letting Darryl Green go.
Klaus Wilmsmeyer back to punt for the 49ers. Brian Mitchell back deep. He'll hang this one high. Mitchell lets it bounce. Didn't make it to the end zone, and the 49ers down it. Chuck Thomas downed it. Was batted backwards.
There are times, Andy said, when it's best to play it safe.
Here for the swamp tour?
Especially when on safari in the Everglades. 14,000 square miles of alligators, snakes, and frogs that bite. So Andy suggested the great-tasting Old Milwaukee non-alcoholic. It's got to get better than this, I said, as Gil, our guide, took us butt-bruising for the day. Good thing for a cold Old Mil N.A. There's enough exhilaration already in the Everglades. And hey, you don't want to end up as gator bait.
It's the weekend, and the Honda automobile plant in Marysville, Ohio, is closed. Everybody's gone home. Well, almost everybody. So, this is a good time to show you around. 10,000 Americans build 3 out of every 5 Hondas sold in America right here in Ohio. In fact, they've been making cars here for 10 years. Well, we won't take up any more of your time. After all, it is the weekend.
It couldn't have happened at a worse time for us. That's the week that we take more catalog orders on our 800 number than any other week of the year. No one can make it into work that day. AT&T saved the day for us.
We had designed their 800 service with such powerful backup features that within minutes, they were able to reroute their calls to other sites around the country. They did a full day of Christmas season business, and no one was there.
If you have a business that lives and dies by an 800 service, you go with the most reliable, and that's AT&T.
Follow number one ranked Duke as they try to topple 2 top 10 foes. Sunday, number 10 Georgia Tech. Next Saturday, number 8 Iowa, only on CBS Sports.
Here's a heck of a play, Pat, here by Martin Harrison. If we watch him here and downing that ball, watch the button. He just runs right by 2 of his own guys, makes a head first dive, and gets that ball back out there.
That's a good thing it was a soft field. A maneuver like that, 1st and 10 from the 4 for the Redskins. They're down 17-3, fake reverse, flag on the play. Outside the ball comes to Monk. Out of bounds at about the 11 by Romanowski.
Yeah, that play had everything. Monk was one of the guys it was faked to before he went out for the pass.
But the penalty is against the Redskins. You know, you get to the playoffs, John, you think about it, they've always
said. Two-man moving on the offense, half the distance to the goal.
The officials sort of back off in the playoff games and let the players play. And you sort of get that impression about this one today with Red Cashin and his crew.
Yeah, I've always felt that, you know, the bigger the game, the less the officials do. But maybe the teams are better, and maybe the games are played better, too.
That's entirely possible. Another flag on the play as Ripken is stopped by Red Cashin, no play.
Before the ball was snapped, false start. Number 79 on the offense. Half the distance to the
again,
goal.
The Redskins go backwards.
And what he was saying, that the offensive line, you see Lachey right there. Jim Lachey, the left tackle, started to move. He's blocking Kevin Fagan. He started to move backwards before the ball was snapped. So then they blow the whistle, so there's no play.
They move it back again. Either Red Cashin's got a sore throat or there's something wrong with his microphone.
We've had to read his lips all day, haven't we? Usually they get those things fixed at halftime.
Ripken back in the end zone to throw it. Good play by Don Griffin. He is perhaps of the 49ers secondary the steadiest, best defender.
Yeah, he is, and he's the veteran. He's the 7-year guy, and he's the best corner they have. He's the best cover guy. In fact, he's one of the best cover guys in the league. And you saw that. I mean, he just had Gary Clark, and he just had that whole thing and made a good break in the ball, got his hand in there. A real quiet guy, a quiet-type leader. You know, a leader who does it by the way he plays rather than any talk.
2nd and 13, Ripken again in the end zone. Going deep. Incomplete and intercepted by Whitmore. Whitmore still down on his feet, out of bounds at the 20 and a flag on the play.
Big play by David Whitmore. That was just desperation by Mark Ripken. I mean, he was just good at it. And he just launched anything he could, anywhere he could. I mean, that was really not a football pass.
That was a throw and hope. They're saying, I believe, that he might have been down back here as a result of contact. His knee did touch the ground. And that's what they're going to rule, I think.
And again, as you said, it has to be down, the knee has to be down, but it has to be a result of contact, too. There has to be contact by the other guy. You could see that his knee went down, but you don't know when the contact occurred. You watch as David Whitmore gets the interception here. He has it now. And I guess the knee is hitting there. And then does Ricky Sanders touch him once the knee hit?
On the interception, the player is ruled down by contact.
And Red catches.
On the play, however, we have unnecessary roughness.
That's what they say. He's downed as a result of the contact. Or while his knee was on the ground, Sanders did make contact with him. Now the penalty is marked off. He was hit out of bounds after the interception. If he was down, how can he get a penalty? I guess it's a personal foul which can't go unpunished.
Yeah, right. That's the thing. You don't just because he's down. I don't know that they blew the whistle, though. You know, that's the other thing. You know, but just because he's down, that doesn't mean that you get a free shot at him. That was okay by Lachey there, and they got Ray Brown for that second hit out of bounds.
So it's a 49er first and 10 at the Redskin 40. 17-3 they lead. Young trying for more. Gets it to Rathman. Rathman head down, pulls for a first down. Gobea and Collins combined to bring him down, but a 12-yard gain.
Yeah, the 49ers do this better than anyone, this bootleg thing where they're going to take their fullback and they just run the fullback right inside the tackle. If you see him coming here, now here's the tackle. Now Rathman is going to come and run his pass route right inside there. So he gets lost in the line of scrimmage, you see? And then he comes right, the tackle lets his guy come up the field and makes a lane for him. Then they bootleg and they let him run in that lane between a guard and tackle.
You say they do it better than anyone else. They do a lot of things better than anyone else.
Well, they work at those little things.
They sure do. Young fakes, got away from one tackler, and he's going to take off himself. Young, still on his feet, finally fell down at about the 16. Ball is loose.
Tell you one thing, when a quarterback goes to throw the ball, you never leave your feet. That's rule run. Fred Stokes did that, and that's why Steve Young was able to run. But the Redskins made up for it at the end of the play. They did get the ball back.
Monty Coleman made the recovery.
Hey, that's Steve Young's second fumble today. Again, he's one of those guys, when he starts to run with the ball, he's reckless with it. And when you get reckless with the ball, then some things happen. You see, he's down now, and he wasn't down by contact. They didn't blow the whistle.
Right.
It was after he got up that he fumbled. If he would have gone down and just stayed down, he would have been okay.
Yeah, he brought some of the field to the sideline with him. Richie Pettibone, as his team gets another turnover. That's their third. Hadn't helped so much so far.
Well, it's kept him in the game. I mean, it could be a blowout without that. Richie Pettibone said that they needed four. They're going to get their four. The problem is we can't give out three.
With the runner before he was down. Since he did not put his head forward, it's a fumble. First down.
What did he say, since he did not put his head forward?
Yeah, he said there was no contact with him the first time he went down.
Right.
And then since he didn't put his head forward, then there was a fumble. I'm not sure exactly what that means, but I know that after he got up, if you can go down, no one touches you, can get up.
Right.
Then he fumbled after he got up.
To those who still believe that only expensive luxury cars should offer standard anti-lock brakes, a driver's side airbag, and sophisticated engine technology, we think you'll come around. The Civic EX sedan from Honda. Next time you're dining out, ponder this. The Discover card pays you a cashback bonus on every meal you charge, which means you shall soon acquire a small fortune. It pays to discover.
There's nothing better than winning a Super Bowl or a NASCAR race. But to finish strong, you have to start fresh. Interstate batteries are fresh. For factory fresh power, call 1-800-CRANK-IT. Start fresh with Interstate.
The defense calls Rebecca Carlson.
You cannot get away with murder.
We don't have probable cause.
Sure I do. Marsha's will leaves all $8 million to your client.
The whole situation was unnatural. He couldn't handle it.
She got off under control. Walk away.
They can't wait to convict me.
All you need is a reasonable doubt.
Body of Evidence. Rated R. Starts Friday at theaters everywhere.
He's a mountain man who lives by the laws of nature, a threat to his enemies, and a hero to a woman called Dr. Quinn tonight.
17-3, the 49ers lead. 7:40 left in the third period. Here's the turnover.
Well, you watch. No one touched him now. Now he's going to stand up, and his own guy, Jesse Sapolo, right there. You see, knee the ball out? Jesse Sapolo kneed the ball out. So when he went down, they didn't blow the whistle. Then he got up, then Jesse kneed the ball right out of his hands, and the Redskins recovered it.
Ryan Mitchell had one man to beat. He couldn't beat Eric Davis. A ramble of 26 yards by Mitchell.
I don't even know if Jesse Sapolo knows that. I mean, those guys
probably
are
not
so big and strong that they hit something like that, they don't even know that they hit it. Here's the famous counter trade. Guard and tackle pull. 49ers wanted to squeeze that, make it bounce out. They didn't squeeze that one. They gave Brian Mitchell an inside hole.
Ripping. Incomplete. High to Gary Clark.
You know, Mark Rippon had such a great year passing last year that everything kind of went his way. And this year in training camp, he held out and he seemed to struggle all year. I mean, today he's 9 for 23. He's thrown 2 interceptions and he just never got into rhythm early in the season, in the middle of the season, or at the end of the season.
Rippon trying to get the screen pass in the middle to Mitchell and does finally. Although the 49ers played it well. Just to clarify that fumble by Steve Young a minute ago, he didn't give himself up by sliding, as quarterbacks often do, is what they're saying. So he started again after he got up and lost the ball and hadn't given up that right. They have protection when they slide like that, is what I'm trying to say.
Right, and he was down and no one touched him, so he was still alive, and then Jesse Sapolo's knee just knocked the ball out of there.
Rippon, good protection. Pass complete. Somehow those two things go together, don't they? Good protection, pass complete.
I'll tell you, that's where it all starts. You can have all these wide receivers, and you can have posses, and you can have Hall of Famers, and you can have tight ends, you can have all this stuff. But if the guys up front don't get the guys blocked, then it's all academic.
First and 10 Redskins as they hurry up. 5:48 left in the third quarter. Mitchell at the line of scrimmage. No gain. Ted Washington and Dennis Brown.
You know, and I'm sure that the Redskins sideline, I'm sure that they're talking about what Buffalo did last week in the second half. I'm sure they're talking about what the Philadelphia Eagles did last week in the second half, probably what they did last week in the second half. And they know that you can come back and win a game in the second half.
They go no huddle. Griffin gets it to Ron Middleton. Middleton, who goes about 270 pounds, gets to the 49er 35, shy of the first down, stopped by Michael Walter.
Ron Middleton is another tackle more than a tight end, and he's used more as a blocker than a receiver.
Not enough for the first down by Mitchell. Ted Washington on the bottom of the pile. Going to be close.
And it's going to be an interesting decision for Joe Gibbs.
Got to go for it.
Down 17-3. Still plenty of time. I don't know. With this footing, it would be tough. I don't know that you don't have enough time to punt the ball here if you don't have a first down. Because I would hate to have to get a first down against a goal line or short yardage defense in the middle of this field. Sure, all Redskin fans right here are hoping for a first down here.
Well, they didn't get it.
goes back to something you've said so many times before. When they get close to a first down, they always know exactly. They can give you a signal with their hands how much you need.
I know it, and the Redskins are going to go for it.
Out of the huddle in a hurry. Ernest Biner in the game. Got to figure he's going to get the ball in the attempt. No, it's the quarterback sneak by Rippon, and he'll get it.
Well, that's why Joe Gibbs is Joe Gibbs. He makes those decisions. And in fact, he made the same decision that you said, that you have to do that, but you worry about being able to do it. I mean, Mark Rippon makes a good play here because he could just as well have slipped and not gotten back to the line of scrimmage.
Of course, Rippon's a great big guy. He goes about 230.
And he's smart enough where he just doesn't go straight ahead behind the center. Raleigh McKenzie went a little to his left.
There's Rippon. Caught by Gary Clark. Somehow he lost it, fumbled it on the ground, and it looks like the 49ers had a shot at it. They may have it.
Hey, that's one thing that a field does is just, you know, balls just fly out everywhere. And this is one of those pileups, Pat, that could change hands once the ball's under there. The guy that had it at first may not have it when those officials find out who has it. There could be some foreign objects and anything down in that pile.
There are some.
The guys could come up and not have all their number left on them.
There's one foreign object in there, Rippon.
Yeah, Gary Clark looks like a warrior in there. You know one thing, he was the guy that fumbled. You know somewhere he was going to be in on that pile fighting to get that ball back. That's why Rippon's in there. He's in there when it happened. Let's Clark come in over the top. The Redskins had it before the pile started, though.
Second down. 15 yards for a first. Rippon back to throw. Gets the ball up the middle to Brian Mitchell. First down. He's down to about the 14. Wrestled down by Eric Davis. 25 yards. Don't count the Redskins out. Not yet.
Brian Mitchell comes out of the backfield. He starts out from the left-hand side. He's going to come into the middle right there. They're just running that pattern against Romanowski. Bill Romanowski had to cover a man-to-man. I tell you, Mitchell is one of those guys who's good in the open field. He's a good punt returner and a good pass receiver. And then, of course, after he gets the ball, he's a good runner.
He weighs 210, about 5'9 and a half, something in that area. Rippon fake to him. All kinds of time. Missed a man on the flat. It's Biner. Gary Clark was in the end zone open, and you'll hear about that.
I'm sure Mark Rippon's going to hear about that. Joe Gibbs will hear about that. Don Bro will hear about that. The whole group, Jim Hannifin, the line coach, the whole group is going to hear about that one. If you just look, you see they got the three guys over on one side, and then the two receivers are running a pattern, one deep in the end zone and the other one. Now, Clark thinks that he ends up open right up there. He started to. He broke open after the ball was thrown.
Second down. Rippon back. No blitz. That's good coverage by Eric Davis. Looked like Rippon had him as a receiver.
Yeah, that was great coverage by Eric Davis because they were going to Gary Clark all the way. Gary Clark came in. He was going to run a corner pattern where you start inside, then you go back to the corner. Rippon watches him all the way. You see Clark starts inside, stumbles a little, then you go back to the corner, into the post, back to the corner, and that is perfect pass defense. That's as good as a corner can play man-to-man coverage.
Here again, that statistic we showed you when they got down here in the first half. Once they get inside the 20, that's when their problems arise. Rippon to throw, the blitz coming. He got rid of it on the way down. Martin Harrison came from behind.
Harrison is a speed guy, and you're going to see him come right around the corner from the bottom of the screen. See 56 right there? He just comes right there, and I don't think that Rippon saw him at first. Then when he did see him, he tried to get away from him and throw the ball at the same time.
Redskins send their field goal unit on from 32 yards out. Chip Lohmiller made one from 19, but he had a tough time in pregame warm-up. Rutledge the holder. Lohmiller is good. And it's 17-6. The 49ers lead it third quarter.
On the river of life, things change. A protection review with your Allstate agent is the best way to make sure you have the right kind of coverage for your home or car. Or to set you on a course with life insurance to provide for you now or in the future. So see your agent for the Allstate Protection Review. You're in good hands with Allstate.
This week, Russ Feeler's in-laws came to Lake Edna, and how better to feed a group like this than the KFC Super Value Buckets? 15 pieces of the Colonel's original recipe, just $9.99, and super-sized buckets of zesty hot wing pieces, also $9.99. Super Value Buckets are here for a limited time.
And thankfully, so are my in-laws.
The KFC Super Value Buckets.
We are KFC. We do chicken right.
Driver's side airbag, a moonroof, a rear spoiler, anti-lock brakes, a Bose music system, and leather interior. Now, who's the fairest of them all?
Tonight on CBS begins with Dr. Quinn, Medicine Woman. Jane Seymour stars in this Western adventure for the whole family beginning at 8 Eastern time. That's followed by Island Adventure with Raven. And then it's The Hat Squad. That's all tonight on CBS.
You don't think that on a rainy day and a cool day and a moist day like this that a guy would need oxygen, but if you're a big old lineman and you're fighting out there against those other big old linemen all day, you need oxygen even on a cold day.
Mark Logan handles Lohmiller's kickoff about a yard deep in the end zone, and down he goes, a flag on the play. John Brantley makes his second tackle on a kickoff today. It's going to be against the 49ers.
Yeah, one thing, the 49ers have been able to move the ball against the Redskins, but I think they've been able to do a lot of things and not take advantage of being able to put them away.
The back, holding number 65 of the receivers, 10 yards from the spot of the hole, be first down at 10.
Yeah, they've had the opportunities. They've been up and down the field, but they haven't put them away. They've let this defending champion stay alive.
2:11 left to play in the third.
Today, there should not be a place where your business plan ends and your information strategy begins. The two should be one. IBM Services can help you pull them together. We have management consultants to help you decide what to do. Systems consultants to show you how. Technical experts to do the job for you. Even an IBM organization who'll run your systems. There's never been so much help from one place before. There's never been a better time to do business with IBM.
Six wheels, a dish on top, and a Winnebago we go. Friends since the second grade. Products of Altoona, PA. That's Jack, the Butch Cassidy of the Poconos. That's me, Andy, now Mr. L.A. The bold to go where no man has gone before. That's Jack's motto. I say, if you can't get there by car, you have no reason being there. Well, here's to new faces and places you don't see in L.A. But I still say, if you got a cold old mill and a view that fits on a 12-inch screen, it doesn't get any better than this.
This is crazy. This is crazy. This is crazy, crazy. Two pizzas, two free crazy breads, two free soft drinks, all for $7.98 at Little Caesars.
Pizza, pizza.
Hocus pocus. It seems everyone is offering financial advice. We put our faith in research, analysis, and experience. Prudential Securities. The most important thing we earn is your trust.
Tomorrow, it's NCAA basketball action on CBS. The number one team in the nation, the Duke Blue Devils. Battle 10th-ranked Georgia Tech. Coverage begins at 3:45 Eastern from Atlanta. That's tomorrow on CBS Sports.
Yeah, boy, this is good hitting weather. You see, see that look, those guys? This is what football's all about.
Down to Rathman. Rathman out to the 20. Tripped up by Mayhew, big hole.
Old Tom Rathman, he gets all that counter stuff. He has to do all the blocking. I mean, he looks like a football player. He looks like a fullback. He does all the blocking. He does all the pounding. Then they give him the counter. Remember we saw that pass that he caught, mm-hmm. There was a counter pass, and then that run was the same type of thing where they hand him the ball. Watch, Ricky Waters starts this way, Rathman goes on a counter the other way with Harris Barton at the lead blocker.
That's Ricky Waters, this time taken down by Mann from the backside. Boy, you think of that counter play that the 49ers ran with number 44 carrying, and you think about the Redskins who made that play famous with number 44.
Yeah, now everyone has some form of that counter play, and you know, in run and pass, but there's still no one that does that play better than the Washington Redskins.
And no one ran it better than Riggins.
Mark Griffin is still trying to. No one did a lot of things better than John Riggins.
That's true.
I'll tell you one thing. You can't go back, but the Redskins wouldn't have that problem inside the 20 if they had John Riggins.
That's also true. Young has the ball slip out of his hands. I don't know if it's a fumble or not. It could be. There was no forward motion of his hand.
Boy, that's an ugly play. Something bad happened there. Yep. The Redskins ball. Red Cashin, the referee, pointed toward the Redskins.
Now Roy Foster says, as he clapped his hands, calm down.
Could be out. I didn't see Red Cashin point. Yeah, that ball goes up, and that's a fumble.
That's what Red called. Yeah. Charles Mann on the ball.
You see, his arm has to be going forward. The arm was going forward, but the arm went forward after the ball came out. Fred Stokes grabs him, tackles him, holds him, which he can, and Charles Mann, number 71, is going to come in and jump on the ball.
Now they won't get up.
I think Steve Young is still down there fighting for the ball. The last time we saw it, though, I thought Charles Mann had it.
Well, we've often said that ball can change hands many times at the bottom of a pile like this.
See, again, now watch the ball come out. See, the ball is out of his hand before his hand goes forward.
This rule is a fumble recovery while Washington. First down.
That was a fumble. First down, Redskins at the San Francisco 15.
And I tell you, that's four turnovers for the San Francisco 49ers. We talked to Richie Pettibone last night. He said, we have to get four turnovers. And that was one, you know, they were all given by Young, and that was one that he knew that he was going to fumble that, but he tried to make it look like a forward pass.
Now the Redskins back in that zone again. This is Biner. Biner to the one. And the ball might have come out again, but they say he was down. The ball did come out, but he was down.
I tell you, now it's the same thing. We're getting that finality mixed with the urgency. You know, the urgency that the team that wins goes on, the team that loses is eliminated. I think that's why every play is so big. Every tackle is so big. Every time the ball is on or near the ground is so big. That was no fumble there.
Nope. That's the end of the third quarter, though, with the score. San Francisco 17, Washington 6. Our coverage will continue after this message from your local station. You're watching the NFL on CBS.
This is CBS.
My dad used to say, a man who said he never had a chance never took a chance. When you're in a restaurant, you have to try new things. You got to experiment, and you can't take the safe road. You have to look at what it takes to make the customer number one. I think American Express customers overall are by far the higher profile customer for fine dining. I've been a member since 1962, one of the originals, I think.
American Express is welcomed at the Sardine Factory and other fishy places.
This royal throne of kings, this happy breed of men, this earth of majesty, this little world.
The airline that's uniting the world, United, now flies nonstop from San Francisco International to London's Heathrow and the land of poets.
This blessed plot, this earth, this realm, this England.
Come fly the friendly skies.
Until now, some thought imported luxury sedans possessed a higher level of engineering. But change is on the horizon. Introducing the 1993 Cadillac Seville STS with the North Star system. At its heart, a 295-horsepower North Star V8. So advanced, its first scheduled tune-up is 100,000 miles. The Seville STS at your Bay Area Cadillac dealers. Changing the way you think about American automobiles.
The Warriors beat the Pistons today at 4:30 on Channel 5.
The NFC Divisional Playoffs. San Francisco 17, Washington 6. First and goal at the one for the Redskins. Griffin doesn't make it.
I think the 49ers that time were waiting for the quarterback sneak. Remember the last time they had the fourth down on the drive that Rippon kept it alive. He went with a quarterback sneak, and I'm sure that the 49ers are playing what they call gap goal line smash, where you just sell out everything to the inside, and if you go play pass or you go anything to the outside, it's usually a gimme.
Gap goal line smash goes with that thing we did about grit and guts and mud. Second down. He came close this time. Touchdown. Touchdown. Not everybody agrees.
I tell you, once the referee, the official puts his hands up, touchdown, down, it doesn't make any difference what anyone thinks. But you talk about something changing. Boy, has that changed. You know, at every point that the Redskins have today are the result of a turnover.
Mo Miller's extra point is good, and 14:36 left to play in the fourth quarter. 17-13.
If you could see inside your suitcase when you travel, you'd see how Samsonite Hard Side protects what's inside. Because Samsonite has a crush-resistant outer shell and a durable hard side construction that's designed to hold up over the long haul.
Daddy, did you bring me anything?
Samsonite Hard Side. After all, you've got your life in there.
For $65,000, this Corvette ZR1 comes with anti-lock brakes, a 3-year, 36,000-mile bumper-to-bumper warranty, and a roadside assistance program. For under $9,000, this Cavalier VL also comes with anti-lock brakes, the warranty, the roadside assistance program. And, unlike the vet, has this handy cup holder. Hey, $65,000 for the vet and no slide-out cup holder? I'd go for the Cavalier.
On earth that I'd rather be than out in the open where it's all plain to see. If it's gonna get done, it's up to you and me. Come on and head for the mountains of bush. Come on and head for the mountains of bush. Beer.
This playoff summary is sponsored by Budweiser.
Steve Young, 3 fumbles, 1 interception. Washington has gotten all their points.
as a result of turnovers. Here's the touchdown again.
See, what happened is Michael Carter works to the outside. That wasn't gap goal line smash. That was goal line adjustment, where he was going to take that outside hole, and then the linebackers were going to take the inside hole. And then Rippon just quarterback sneaked into that inside hole before the linebackers got there.
Low Miller's kickoff is deep. Logan stays in the end zone. It'll be first and 10, 49ers from the 20. Steve Young back onto the field. Do you get the feeling, still, as they said yesterday, that no matter what happens outside of an injury, we won't see Montana?
Yeah, I still believe that. I believe that this is Steve Young's season. This is Steve Young's team. This is Steve Young's game. And I think that they had a number of opportunities to put it away, and they didn't put it away, and now they're going to have to play a heck of a fourth quarter.
First and 10 at the 20. Water. And he struggles for 5 yards. Monty Coleman led the tacklers.
You know, sometimes everything in the halftime, you know, you start off and you have that first drive and everything goes so easy that it comes back and haunts you later. I mean, it just seems like, you know, they've had the ball three times this second half, and you can see that they would get stuff going and then they would fumble it away. Sometimes it looks like it's too easy and you lose something, including the ball.
Second and 5. Rathman on that counter. It worked last time. That time they got a couple. Stopped by Tim Johnson.
Well, you know, anytime you get a fullback like Tom Rathman, a big old guy out of Nebraska and a blocker who got stingers all the time going down his arm, he's going to cut that thing in tight. Harris Barton, the right tackle, went outside, and he wanted Rathman to bounce that thing outside and follow him. Well, your name's Tom Rathman, and your number's 44, and you've been playing this league 7 years. You don't bounce anything to the outside.
He started this game weighing about 230. Now the mud knocked away. A.J. Johnson. Three and out. And remember that pass, the first 49er touchdown that went through his hand?
Have you come back and you think about that? But I'll tell you, Steve Young had such a good start where everything was going his way, including that pass that A.J. Johnson missed in the first half. And now, in the second half, he's lost the momentum and he's starting to struggle a little.
Wilmsmeyer got his mouthpiece on the side of his helmet. I've never seen it worn there before.
You gotta get it in your mouth.
A good punt. That may be a good place for it. Bounces backwards. The Redskins will take over at their own 23. Down by Antonio Goss. Look at his mouthpiece. No teeth up there.
If you depend on your truck to last, here's news you should never forget. Of all the Chevy trucks built in the last 10 years, over 98% are still going strong. That's more than Ford, more than Toyota, more than Nissan. Over the years, no other truck is that dependable, foreign or domestic. Only Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
And action.
McDonald's Egg McMuffin sandwiches. They don't really do anything, but they taste really good. And now you can get two of them for just $2.
And cut. Thanks, guys. That was great.
The surface of a strange, distant planet? No, two tantalizing McDonald's Big Mac sandwiches. Now get them both for just $2.
What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Deep in a remote jungle? Nope. Two Big Macs for $2. You mean you forgot already?
Those smart folks at Magnavox have asked me to tell you about all their highly intelligent products in just 15 seconds. You must be joking.
Impossible.
No way.
Don't be ridiculous.
The nerve. That's it. I quit.
Magnavox. Smart. Very smart. Imagine a rent-a-car company that offers special delivery right to your door. That's Enterprise.
Here, let me help you.
Enterprise. A special rent-a-car company that gives you special delivery.
CBS Sports coverage of the National Football Conference Divisional Playoff is sponsored by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Smooth Busch beer and easy-drinking Busch Light. And by Dean Witter. Dean Witter measures success one investor at a time.
12:58 left to play. 49ers 17, Redskins 13. Monk in motion. Rippon. Clark. First down, Washington at the 45. Knocked down by Eric Davis.
You know, it's an interesting thing in this game, whether you call it momentum or you call it confidence or whatever you call it. The 49ers had it in the first half, and the Redskins have it in the second half. Here, Gary Clark just comes all the way across the field. You get in that zone, you get behind the linebackers and in front of the defensive backs, and you find that cross alley, and you just run in that cross alley.
And you pick up 22 yards, and you get a first down.
And you had good pass protection.
Biner to midfield, stopped by Pierce Holt.
You know, talking about good pass protection, Pat, Jim Lachey, the big tackle for the Redskins, is out. He has bad ribs, and Joe Jacoby, number 66, has been in there playing for him. And you know, you lose one old warrior and Jim Lachey, and then you get a real old warrior and a tough guy in Joe Jacoby.
What a substitute to have.
I would think any place that I was going to go and anything I was going to do, I would probably want to take number 66 with me.
Second and six. Biner gets into 49er territory. Four more yards, stopped by Ted Washington. They'll need two for a first.
Well, the Redskins came back in the second half and they started to play Redskin football, which is the thing we talked about at halftime, being able to run the ball. Now they're running the ball with Biner and Brian Mitchell and being able to stop the run. They're stopping the 49ers. So the first half was not Redskin football. The second half is Redskin football.
Third and two. Well, Sanders in motion. Ripon's going to throw. Got his first down to Sanders. Inside the 49er 40 to the 37, a pickup of nine. And stopped again, by Griffin.
And again, he has excellent pass protection. You see, they end up in a triple formation, three wide receivers on one side. Sanders runs an option pattern. He starts in. If the guy has covered him to the inside, he runs it out. But watch his pass protection. The toughest pass protection is the side the quarterback's throwing to. That's the side where Joe Jacoby and Ray Brown were, because you not only have to block your man, but you have to create a passing lane.
First down, Rippon to throw it again. Has a man. Pass caught. Gary Clark again. Another first down, Washington.
And Joe Jacoby's doing a heck of a job of pass protecting
really
over
is.
There. Yeah, we talk about an old warrior guy's been in this league for 12 years, has everything bad, shoulders, neck, arms, knees, hips, everything. But I tell you, he is really pass protected on these last couple of plays. And he's the guy that has given Rippon the time and the lane and the area to throw to.
And to think, when he first came to the Redskins, they tried to make him play defense.
And to think that when he came out of college, he wasn't drafted. He was a free agent.
They leave it on the ground, and the 49ers come with it. Brian Mitchell lost it on the handoff.
These fans know how big a play
Walter.
That was.
He's got the handle now. That's where he lost it.
That was Rippon. He didn't. He's supposed to hand that ball off. It started to come out of Rippon's hand before it got to Mitchell. Watch this. Rippon never gets the ball to Brian Mitchell. He's supposed to hand it to him. The ball started to fall out of his hand. You want it in the pocket, just about where the front of your numbers are, and the ball hits him a little low. You see it? It slipped out of Rippon's hands. As he started to, the ball slipped out, and instead of being a handoff, it was slipped into Brian Mitchell.
It was not Mitchell's fault. It just slipped away from Rippon on the exchange. Four turnovers apiece. Young scrambling out of the pocket. This is planned. Steve Young down at the 40. Monty Coleman. 12 yards for Steve Young. 49er first down. Clock running with just over 9 minutes left.
You know, the interesting thing that Jerry Rice hasn't caught a pass yet this half. We talked about how you have to get Jerry Rice involved. I think that was a big part of the 49ers' success in the first half. And I think that they better get him involved again in this game yet.
First down, 49ers at the 40.
Because if you loosen things up with Jerry Rice, then that makes a lot of things possible. If you don't loosen up with him, then the whole defense can tighten up on you.
Rice is the man in motion. Handoff is to Waters. Ricky Waters outside the 45. A pickup of 6. Coleman made the stop with help from the safety man, Brad Edwards. Montana loosens again.
You know what Ricky Waters can do so well, Pat, is spin. And, you know, I mean, a lot of guys at the end of the run, they'll explode. And that's the way they finish off a run. Ricky Waters, at the end of his run, he spins. So you go to tackle him, and you come up with air a big part of the time. Watch him here as he comes. Instead of just taking that guy and finish, you see that spin? Now what that spin does, it gets him a couple more yards, but he doesn't take that big impact.
A little bit of changing at the line of scrimmage, and Young is sacked for a loss on the backside by Jason Buck. Remember Jason Buck? The people in Dallas do.
I'll tell you, they do. Watch Jason Buck. He's going to come free. And again, it's going to be Steve Young's backside. Steve Young, first of all, is looking to the left. He doesn't see or feel Jason Buck come from that side.
Third and 10. There's Buck, who caused the fumble in the Dallas game. That let the Redskins hang in this playoff picture. Darryl Green is one of the defenders. Young has time, and he gets Jerry Rice. As you said, A.J. Johnson made the stop.
Yeah, that changes the whole game. When you get Jerry Rice into the offense, that changes the whole game. And the guy is the best receiver who's ever played the game for a reason. And when he's not used, then that goes against you. When he is used, then that hurts the other team.
No matter who the other team is.
Because now they have to say Jerry Rice. Now they got to put a double on Jerry Rice. Now they have to loosen up. So that gets some Brent Jones stuff going. That gets your running game going. That gets Taylor. That gets a lot of other things going.
And Rice, the connection, gets the first down and keeps the clock going. Young.
Oh.
Rice. The Redskins say he didn't have it.
And this is the time, it's just a plain hook. You talk, you see what he did to A.J. Johnson? A.J. Johnson was going down. He thought he was going deep. He really ran him off. He finally comes back into the thing, but he looked like he did get his hands underneath there.
I think he did. From our angle, he certainly did.
But you know, when you can go deep and you're respected like Jerry Rice is, you just run a little hook. And the cornerback, in that case with A.J. Johnson who's covering you, will run the up for you.
Second and one. Look out for Rice again. Well, we'll watch Waters get the first down. And Moore got 5 yards. They needed one.
Someone just kicked Waters in the head. Did you see that? Waters was down there and some guy put a foot in his head. You can't do that to the guy. He's a fun guy, though. Ricky Waters is... has brought a lot of running to this team, and he's brought a lot of life to it too. I mean, he's a guy that everyone kids in practice, and he kids everyone in practice, and that guy has more energy than probably any 10 players on this team.
He reminds you of Roger Craig in his heyday.
He reminds me of a whirling dervish. I don't know what that is.
Young to Waters again. Strong. Bigger than you think. 3 yards on his own.
Hey, he knew that then. He's looking for something now. I mean, He's looking to break a big one here. He said that all week, all the players were telling him the words, you know, our back's against the wall, that, you know, it's a short season, it's a new season, Super Bowl. And he said, well, what am I going to do different? I only know one way to play anyway. What am I supposed to do? I can't go any higher than I get.
Well, that's all we've ever seen. Down close to 4 minutes left to play now. Jones goes to Redskins. The pass was to Rice, incomplete. Covered by A.J. Johnson. And that was close.
And you're not going to see Jerry Rice drop a lot of passes, but he has A.J. Johnson. He has him going and thinking now. And that pass is right there, and he just let it get too close to him. I mean, Jerry, that was a perfect pass. And I tell you, he has good pass protection, and he's had it all the time here. See Harris Barton on Charles Mann up there? You got that thing, you just get that hand up in there so the guy can't get that inside on you.
Just bounced off his body. Third and seven. See if the Redskins come on a blitz. They don't look like it. It's a three-man run. Get it outside to Rathman, and Rathman, with his head down, is a little bit short of the first down. Darryl Green up to assist on the tackle.
And this is going to be an interesting call here for George Seifert. Again, I think in this, see, the score is 17-13, where a touchdown can beat you.
They're going for it. And I think that's a very intelligent call. I agree with you. Touchdown can beat you.
Well, you know, the thing is, as it stands now, if they put three on, then it would be 20, so then a touchdown could tie them.
They need to get to the line for the first down. Talk about a foot or a season or whatever. This could be it. The finality of the whole thing for one of these two teams. They get the first down. Not over yet by any means, but it surely would help the 49er cause.
Would start you up that road.
Young on the quarterback sneak has it for 2 yards. Wasn't really a straight ahead sneak. He went almost over the right tackle to get it.
Yeah, he started out over the right guard, Roy Foster, and then ended up in there between Foster and Harris Barton. I think that's a good place to run a quarterback one way or the other. But watch him. He's going to start here, and you see that? There's Foster. There's Harris Barton. He darn near got all the way outside of Harris Barton. But he was going down that line and trying to find a soft spot. And he found that soft spot, really, in what you call the six hole, the off tackle hole.
Young has 75 yards and 7 carries. They go in a hurry. Waters to about the 18. Clock still running. Timeout Redskins with 2:38 left to play. And the 49ers leading 17-13.
These three such very good friends wanted a glorious son of St. Thomas. But one evening, the tall one lost her money and her credit cards. And as soon as she mentioned Citibank Visa, no problem, I told her. Call this minute. Go on. They're open all the time. Well, she got a new card in one day. I see credit cards from all around the world. And with Citibank, it's always the same thing. No problem.
Not just Visa. Citibank Visa.
At the LaPorte Vineyards, owners Victor and Beth LaPorte knew varietal grapes, but profit sharing and pension plans they knew little about. So they turned to someone who gave their financial needs the same care they accorded their wine. Dean Witter.
Where we invest is in the individual. What we invest is our time, our expertise, and our care.
So the LaPortes can now not only enjoy success, they can taste it. Dean Witter.
We measure success one investor at a time.
Thank you.
For those who want to drive something really foreign, the Lumina. Fully independent sports suspension, anti-lock brakes, fuel-injected V6. For more details and a test drive, see your Chevrolet dealer.
2 minutes, 38 seconds left to play. This drive by the 49ers has consumed 6 minutes and 45 seconds. Valuable time.
I think that's the key thing, because the Redskins were just taking the game over. They had the confidence. They had the momentum. They had everything. The 49ers got the ball, and they kept it, like you said, for almost 7 minutes now.
Second and nine. 49ers at the Redskin 18. Young out of the pocket. Going deep. Incomplete. For Rice. Covered by Johnson in the end zone. This game presented by authority of the National Football League, the CBS telecast intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of CBS, the 49ers, and the National Football League is prohibited. Third and nine. They use 5 seconds. It's 2:33 left to play. San Francisco 17, Washington 13. Third and nine. A handoff to Ratman. To about the 14. A timeout, Washington.
And the 49ers went for it on the fourth down. And again, they didn't go for the field goal then, but now they have to go for the field goal. So you say, well, they have to go for the field goal anyway. But the two things they did is they took some time off the clock, and of course, they got better field goal position for Mike Cofer.
Most kickers are better, particularly soccer-style kickers, from the right hash mark.
Yeah, because they all have that hook.
The natural hook.
But the one thing that he's worried about, as you see him there, is his plant foot. You know, that when he puts that left foot down, that it doesn't slide. You see him keep working that left foot there. That's one. It's not the right foot that's going to do the kicking. I think he feels pretty confident about that. But if he has any question in his mind right now, it's his left or plant foot.
If he should slip. He picks up a divot and moved it. And all the housekeeping help. It's good. San Francisco 20. Washington 13. 2:22 left to play. The Redskins have only one timeout left. Cofer.
Everyone has a celebration. You know, the ironic thing about this is that was a big kick for Mike Cofer. And early in the season, well, in fact, in the preseason, these two teams played in London. And Mike Cofer, there was talking about he wouldn't make the team, that he may be cut. He made a big kick to beat the Redskins in a preseason game in London. But maybe more important than beat them in a preseason game, kept his job. There was talk that he was going to be cut, that they were going to make a change. But that kick, they say, saved his job.
And he still has it. Today's game was produced by Bob Stenner and is directed by Sandy Grossman. The coordinating producer of the NFL Today is Eric Mann. The NFL Today was directed by Duke Struck, and the senior producer of the NFL on CBS is Ed Gorin. Cofer kept his job. Now he can put up a sign after that field goal.
The Redskins still have 2 minutes and 22 seconds to tie this game with a touchdown.
Short kick. Danny Copeland takes it at the 12. Scrambled around. Got out to about the 22. 10-yard return. Mark Logan down to make the stop. Logan always excellent on special teams. Rippon 18 out of 35. Two interceptions.
246 yards. He scored the Redskin touchdown.
Hey, and Mark Griffin has struggled all year, but he's hung in there all year. I mean, he's taken his share of shots on the field and off the field, and now he has 2 minutes to get a touchdown.
2:12 left. The ball on the 22-yard line. The Redskin 22. So Griffin back to throw it. And now he's going to run. Pierce Holt will be the last to get up.
And that was excellent coverage down here. He was trying to go to Art Monk, and that wasn't as much. He's rolling out, and he's going to go down here to number 81, Art Monk. Now watch Eric Davis here. Again, good coverage. Eric Davis has made some big plays today. You see, and they had Monk double. That's who he was looking for. That's who he wanted to throw to. He couldn't, and he took the sack.
2 minute warning. 2 minutes left.
He's history's most celebrated quarterback. Now he's coaching Budweiser in Bud Bowl 5. Yes, some men are born to be football legends.
Give every last drop. We're going to win. We're Budweiser.
Of course, some men aren't.
We'll win it, because we're Bud Light.
You ever wonder how they get the strings in these things?
Bud Bowl 5. It's back. Get your ticket where you buy Bud, Bud Light, and Bud Dry. Someone will win $1 million in cash.
The higher you go, the more power you need.
Like a rock, I was strong as I could be. Like a rock, nothing ever got to me.
That's why up here they depend on the most horsepower ever in a turbo diesel pickup.
Like a rock.
Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
I do this every day.
9 years as of last Wednesday.
2.5 years.
A little bit under 5 years.
I've been there 14 years.
I work in the shipping department.
I'm traffic manager.
Shipping manager.
8 years.
14 years.
10 years next October.
What overnight service would I recommend?
Of all the shipping companies?
Who would I recommend?
Coast to coast.
Coast to coast.
10:30 guaranteed.
10:30 guaranteed. We use UPS.
UPS. The best overnight delivery service is UPS.
Send it out Tuesday, it gets there Wednesday.
If they say it's 10:30, absolutely it's 10:30.
They pick up when they say they're going to, and they deliver when they say they're going to.
Anything that makes my job easier, I like.
Tomorrow, starting at 12 Eastern, Philadelphia travels to Dallas to battle the Cowboys. The playoffs return to Dallas for the first time since 1983. And Jimmy Johnson's team has had 2 weeks to prepare for the next phase of America's team's rebuilding program, advancing to the championship game and perhaps beyond that to the Super Bowl. The Cowboys and the Eagles, starting at 12 Eastern with the NFL Today, tomorrow, here on CBS. Second and 16 in Ripon. Incomplete. Into the hands and out of Brian Mitchell.
Boy, that was a big drop there, because that was not only a completion, it would have got him out of bad field position, but it would also have given him a first down.
How confetti tastes.
I think someone probably had that idea. Okay, we'll bring the confetti, and if and when the 49ers win, we will throw it all over ourselves. That's a little early. You got to wait.
A minute 55 left to play. 20-13. 49ers leading. Ripon again. Back to throw. Caught by Clark. That gives him breathing room. Thane Gash on the stop, a 24-yard gain. No huddle.
It gives him breathing room. It gives him a whole new set of downs, and it gives him a lot better field position. And again, remember, they're driving for a touchdown. A field goal's no good.
And they've had difficulty getting into the end zone. Here's Ripon. Down he goes. They only have one timeout left. Dennis Brown made the sack on Ripon. They'll stop the clock there with a minute 25 left.
Again, I think that was a coverage sack. They did the same thing earlier. Mark Ripon rolled. They had coverage on Monk. He had to take a sack, and he took one there.
Second and 14. They started the clock again after the sack. Flag on the play. Way downfield. Ripon goes down. The 49ers have the ball. Martin Harrison fell on it. He made the tackle. I'm not sure who fell on it, but the flag was way downfield. It's against the 49ers.
And the Redskins did fall on it, so it's their ball anyway.
Holding, number 26 on the defense. 5 yards, first down.
That's a first down, holding against Magruder. There it is.
Yeah, and that's the big thing. A couple of big things. One, that they caught him. He almost took Clark's jersey off right there. But it also, again, it gives him a new set of downs, and it stops the clock.
1:05 left. Ripping to throw. Maybe. Again, he's sacked. This time by guess who? Here's Holt.
Hey, if there's anyone who's been a nemesis today for Mark Rippon in that passing pocket, it's been Pierce Holt. Not only when he sacked him, but he's been around there. He's been knocking him around. He's been stepping in front of him. He's been doing all those things. The 49er bench does get in this game. They're telling the fans, come on, there's only 55 seconds.
Timeout, Redskins. That's their last one. 55 seconds left on the clock. 20-13. Pierce Holt has 3 sacks.
Again, he's had a big day against Mark Schlereth there mostly. And once Pierce Holt, he's listed as an end, but he plays a lot at tackle. In fact, most of his plays and his sacks are coming from that tackle position. Once a tackle breaks loose in the middle, boom, he's right in a quarterback's face.
He should be listed as a player.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, he's just a football player. He looks like a football player, and he acts like a football player, and probably the most important thing when it comes out here on Sunday,
he is.
Plays like one, and every guy, whoever plays against Pierce Holt, will tell you that the guy's motor runs 100% of the time. It never runs down. It never runs slow. It's always going at full-out round.
Well, the 49ers took a lot of grief from a lot of people for drafting him. He'd been painting houses and doing all kind of things. Played at a minor college, small college. They won't like that.
Yeah, well, he's from Angelo State.
Here's Rippon. Clark was the intended receiver. Art Monk was the intended receiver. Out of bounds in front of the 49er bench. Third down.
Joe Gibbs is one of the few head coaches in the league that calls his own plays. That's his game plan there. He has that written out just on a yellow pad. Always thinking ahead. Knows exactly what every situation is. Knows who's in the game, what they do best. Knows all the matchups.
Third down at 17. The protection is good. The pass is incomplete. Through the hands of Ricky Sanders, it would have been enough for a first down. 41 seconds left to play.
Mark Rippon is doing his part. As you said, that went right through Ricky Sanders' hands. We had one early where Brian Mitchell went right through his hands. So again, Mark Rippon has taken criticism this year. Some of it, you know, he's had some problems, but everything that goes wrong with the Redskins offense is not Mark Rippon.
Mark Rippon breaks him out of the huddle. This is the Redskins season. 4th-17. They need a first. 41 seconds left to go. Rippon, all the time in the world. Better get rid of it. He does, incomplete. Middleton had it go right through his hand. Rippon couldn't find anyone to throw to. Now, the men in red can celebrate. Crowd can start to tramp through the mud. The 49ers will advance.
Now they can pull out that confetti.
Yeah. And the championship game will be right here.
Yeah, like I said, there's no better feeling than winning a playoff game that takes you to a championship game, and there's no lower feeling than losing it. The Redskins, defending champion.
You think about a guy like Jacoby, whom we just had a shot of, could be his last game. Joe Jacoby, and what a warrior he's been.
And he kind of represents his whole team. I mean, the Redskins, they've had their injuries. They've had everything go against them that they could, and they just fought through it. And, you know, and they got here to this position. This is as far as they could get, but they had a great year anyway.
Remarkable achievement.